Love it, love it, love it, love it, love it, love it. All right, I just love it. 19 minutes on the other side of 11, and as I welcome you in this segment that we all normally open the phone line at this time and have a conversation, and you know, like I said, the basis of the conversation, opening the phone line, the interaction, is for the edifying, for the building up of the faith, that we can reason together as brethren in Christ, that we can strengthen ourselves and be better in the things of the Lord. We can be able to be stronger as one body in Christ, all believers together under one umbrella, heading for the same goal, to achieve the same goal as believers in the same one, Jesus Christ. So that is the motive, that is the motivation, that we can reason as brethren, as one believer in Christ, that we can better ourselves and have a closer and better walk. As each one teach one, we help to pick each other up as brethren, and we can continue to do this walk. So that's basically what it is about. And that's why we open the phone lines and we conversate with the intention that we are able to be as brothers and sisters in Christ. And on common ground, we can discuss back and forth, but always to get a positive outcome on whatever is administrated in the conversation. That is the general intention. It's not to bring up strife. It's not to be against anyone. And that is totally not our intention. And we hope that as believers in Christ, we have the same motive if we are following the exact same person. Because the rules and the regulation is the same for each and every follower who follows Christ. So today the conversation we want to open up today basically is, who are we following really? Based on our actions, our activities, our emotions, how we function as believers in Christ, who are we following really? Who are we really following? I remember sometime in the week I heard a lady call the radio and was talking about the way people dress as believers in Christ. And mind you, she had a very, very, you know, crucial, very potent and important topic of discussion. It was a very, you know, really realistical point that she raised. You know, that as believers in Christ, we all should dress appropriately based on the holiness of Christ. That's normal. This is normal. But then she went further on to start saying that you pastors on the radio, you fooling people and you're teaching people wrong stuff. And, you know, that's not God. That's not Jesus. You know, that's not, you know, it's like you defeated the whole purpose as you went on to go into other areas talking. You came with one great point and then you went on with a bunch of stuff that really and truly, as much as Jesus would have said the first part, or adhere or say yes, I say okay to the very first part of the conversation, when you start criticizing other pastors because of what they dispense, how they dispense it, immediately you're moving away from the great thing that you just established. You know what I mean? So I'm saying all this to say that we as believers in Christ, if we're following one master, then we need to be able to relate to each other based on the leading of the Holy Spirit and based on the leading of Jesus Christ. So that's really and truly what it is, because don't care what religion you follow, then it shouldn't really take away if Jesus is the key and Jesus is the focal point of your religion base or of your belief. You know what I mean? If Jesus is the one that we're following, certain things should not happen because we're following Jesus. And Jesus left a lot of rules and regulation and things that he do and would not do, so that we know if we're following him, we should be on a certain way to know that, well, okay, we are following Jesus. You know what I mean? So that is basically the conversation. It's not really what I just said about the dressing, but I'm just trying to show you that we as believers, we need to be in one accord if we are following the same Jesus. We might have different interpretation, different revelations of the scripture, which is, you know, understandable, because that's why they said the word of God is alive. And it is alive, because you and I can read the exact same scripture and get different revelations from the same scripture, but they both can align to each other in many different facets. They might be for different reasons based on who the reader is. God reveals His word to different people based on their circumstances, based on their situation, based on the whatever it is. That's the way that the word goes. That's why the word is alive, because every man is different. So the word relates to you in one way that it doesn't relate to me. But if we are in same unison as believers, then I am able to adhere to what it revealed to you and understand why it will reveal to you that way, and vice versa. You following the same master, who is not the author of confusion, should be able to see what I'm saying and understand it for who we following, and we should not be in confusion. You see what I'm saying? So if you understand what I'm talking about and you want to call and share testimony or something that you have, you know, gone through as a believer, and things that you have noticed as a believer in, you know, in your walk, we can start the conversation and we can all be able to look into the mirror of our Christian walk and see where we might be going wrong or going away from the track as we follow Jesus, as we follow Christ. All right, so the number here, 347-663-8638. And if you're going to call me, I'd like you to stay on the topic that we'd like to relate to. Just keep it in the context. The number 347-663-8638. Who are we following? Are we following Jesus? As I said before, I noticed, we cannot tell people what to listen, who to listen. But I noticed a lot of different people who normally used to, you know, call. They don't call. If they do call, it's like a, almost like a confusion rather than a conversation. You know what I mean? And I say good morning to the first caller. Caller, good morning to you. Could you please turn off your radio? Caller, turn off your radio, please, sir. Please turn off your radio.
My radio is not on.
All right, sir, go ahead.
Now.
Good morning.
The Bible says, come, let us reason, said the Lord. Is that true?
Yes, it does say, come, reason. Yes, sir.
All right. Now, you see, you're going to stick to the topic, what you were saying just now. I heard the ladies call last week, okay? But you got to take the good with the bad. Every day you got to reprove yourself.
Amen.
Okay? Not because the lady say what she said. She said some good to me, all what she says is true. So you don't have to get offensive about it, because some people or some pastors, the way they interpret things, and if you get to that point where you get to Bible school and you've been taught and then you've been led by the Holy Spirit, some of the things that they say is not really going that way, okay?
I don't understand what you mean. Make a clearer distinction in what you're trying to state in this conversation.
Okay. Like some pastors try to get into areas of the law and all like that, how the law was being done away with and all like that. And they really do not have the real thing to really...
What is the real thing? What is the real thing? What is the real thing?
Okay, they do not have the real spiritual teaching. They do not have the eyes to see and to touch on certain topics.
Let me ask you, who when you say the spiritual teaching, who can teach you spirit? Who can teach you? Who can teach you spirit?
Okay. The Bible said, if any man lack knowledge, right?
Mm-hmm.
Let him come to the Spirit, okay? And the Spirit will teach you.
Oh.
Again, the Bible says that men are to always pray. Again, how many hours that our pastors, are we pastors, spend the days in front of God? We talk more than we listen.
Let me ask you a question, caller. Sorry to just come in right there. How do you know how many hours pastors pray? How do you know that?
How do I know that? Because I know pastors, some of them, most of them work. You understand what
let
I mean?
Me ask
most
you, of them work. Let me ask you, are you a believer in Jesus Christ? Do you believe in Jesus Christ?
Yes, I am.
Now, you called the radio, and the very first initial conversation was about the lady that called, and then I was saying to you that when she called, she came with something very good, regardless of what her religion, what it is. She came with something very good in talking about Christian believers should be able to dress appropriately that would relate to the holiness of Christ. I told you, it was a very good and great conversation she brought up. Unfortunately, she went further to start passing judgment as to what is being administrated by pastors. Unfortunately, if you're a follower of Christ, that is not the appropriate way or the appropriate road to take in criticizing others, because he said to come and let us reason. If you don't understand why I say something, you might need to ask me a question. And if my answer does not fit in alignment with the Word of God, then you have a credible source to come back and counteract what was said to you, because now I give you a reason. Now there is a basis for everything that is being said. Now if a person call with the intention of educating themselves or familiarizing themselves with what has been dispensed, and their motive is correct, they wouldn't have a problem with what is being said, unless someone transgress against what they are trying to say. You see what I'm saying to you? So making an assumption that people are talking stuff, if you don't ask a question, why did you say this? This is not appropriate according to scripture. Then a person decide to go against what you tell them, now you have reason to say, well, this person is not adhering to the Word of God based on the context.
Okay. Now, how do you know that the person's motive is wrong?
Well, the Bible said, by the fruit you shall know them. So if the fruit of what is being dispensed is not in alignment with the Word of God, obviously it's going to create a contention. How can
how do you know that it is not in alignment with God? Tell me.
Okay, let me ask you a question. What this lady who said that is in alignment with the Word of God in terms of saying that pastors are saying this and saying that?
Okay, let me quote you now. Remember when Christ was preaching out in the street and so, what did he call the people them who was preaching lies? And they were looking up to them. People were looking up to them and say that these are men of God, right? But they were telling the people them lies, and people and God talk about them. God speak about those people. Okay. What I'm trying to say to you, just because someone say that pastor, you don't hear every pastor. You understand? You don't go to every church, right? But what I'm telling you, what the lady was saying, some pastors, she never said all pastors, some. And double.
She said you pastors on the radio. She said you pastors on the radio.
If you get double, listen to me. Listen to me. You're a young believer, but listen to this, right? You love Christ, okay? And you're passionate about it. It's good, but listen to what I'm saying to you. When you or to get out and go to other churches and sit and to listen and to hear something, you will get up and walk out. I'm telling you. You understand what I'm saying to you?
I understand what you're saying to me, but we are...
Then listen to me what I'm saying to you. You just keep your ears open, okay? So when you hear it coming out of somebody's mouth, you're going to say to yourself, oh my God, I heard that lady say something like that. I never believe that. As you go spiritually, you'll go to church with double, and you'll get up and leave. I know what I'm telling you. You hear me?
You understand? So I understand what you...
I just reason with you. Don't just take it and just say, oh, it's like if I tell you, my thing is to tell you, there's a man down the street who's doing this thing which is wrong. Double, don't walk down there. But because you never see the man, you never heard about the man, you follow and go down there. It says you must all never think this world, okay, is the devil run thing, okay? And the devil is also the angel of light, okay? And he can disguise himself very...
How the devil could be an angel of light? If you say you want to disguise like a... My brother, let me ask you something, brother. Let me tell me. You're going all over the place with your conversation.
No, I know.
You're going everywhere with your conversation. You're going every single way.
Because I knew something and my experience, okay? That's why you go to churches which the pastor can take you step by step and walk you through. I I passed that stage, you understand? So because I passed that stage, you will feel like I'm going all over the place. But the truth is this, if we sit down with a Bible and I to go into every scripture and to show you and to explain every scripture, precept by precept, promise, promise. Because when you're so spiritually filled, spiritually inclined, and you move to the stage level, you're gonna do the same thing, you're gonna see these things, you're gonna hear them things, you're gonna walk away. Just like right now, these are stunned things that sick in your stomach, you're gonna sick your stomach as it gets your whole length, right? Trust me. I listen to you every day. I got that on call. Your passion is there. But don't take everything people say and thing with it. Search the scripture. You're gonna find it there.
All right, my brother. Thank you for your call and thank you for your contribution.
Everyone, that's a lot, lot.
All right. Thank you very much. Indeed, of course.
All right, brother.
All right, boss. Thank you
so
very much.
Continue to reason, okay?
Amen. Right. 34 minutes on the other side of 11 o'clock, and I don't know what you got from the caller. That, you know, I don't know what you got, but I don't know what, you know. But overall, you know, what I was saying, nothing is staying on my stomach. I said to you that, based on what the caller said, the caller called with one great point, and then she went on to start to criticize preachers and pastors on the radio. I'm saying that if you don't ask a question, why did you say this? Why did you say this like this? Or get the information, contact them. This is what God asks us to do. As believers in Christ, if we're following the same God, we all are brothers and sisters in Christ. So we and our intention is not to criticize each other, but able to enlighten each other and be able to be as brethren and sisters in Christ as we are willing to sit down and search the scriptures together and able to go through. So I'm saying to you, she came with one good point talking about the way people dress, and I'm giving her credit because it's a credible conversation. And the pastors on the radio were saying, well, many people, yes, they go to church, but they have not been filled with the Holy Spirit, because the Spirit is what's going to lead you to do what is right in the eyes of God. A person might just go to church, but they have not been filled with the Holy Spirit, because the Holy Spirit will lead you into all truth, even in the truth of dressing and what is appropriate in the eyes of God, or what is appropriate as just to dress. In terms of being in the house of the Lord, where people are, this is something natural that you don't really have to teach people that. If they are filled with the Holy Spirit, they will just do it naturally, because they will just know, because of the holiness of God, they wouldn't dress a certain way. But I'm saying to you, she went further on after she made such a great point that, you know, we don't really talk about too much. She went to criticize and say that you pastors this and you pastors that. And the show is being recorded, and if you go online, you can listen back to the show. But I'm saying to you is that if the motive of the caller, as a believer, know that we are all in the same body of Christ, then our intention is to be able to build up each other, not to tear down, not to break apart, not to cause separation. There are many religions who don't believe in other religions and what they do. And instead of they come and try to light a candle that the people can see what they have seen, instead they criticize and they condemn and they don't talk to them. As a matter of fact, they condemn them and say they're worshiping this and they're worshiping that. And the other people are not criticizing you. They are not against you. They are just in love with you. So which side is doing what God says? Which side is really, and this is what we're trying to say. If we are all believers in Christ, our intention should be for our edifying and for our strengthening us, so we can be an army. Remember when the Spirit appeared and the Holy Ghost filled, they were all in one accord. If there is no one accord, the power of the Holy Spirit is not able to manifest itself through Choice Radio or any radio if everybody's going different direction. You know, and that is the basic fundamental of the conversation. So we all need to be in one accord. You understand me? And many people find themselves in a position where because somebody don't believe what they believe, or somebody's not into what they're into, they totally resent and stay away. The Bible said to come and make you fishers of men. How do you fish? How do you fish for somebody if you don't go to them? If you don't try to find a way to work with them, you cannot fish them. They won't come and take your bait. So we have to find a way that we can incorporate and we can deal with each other as believers in the same Christ. Unless if you serve in one Christ, if we go in two different directions, we would not end up in the same place. You understand what I'm saying? So the number 347-663-8638, And, you know, like I said, we all need to look in the mirror and see, who are we following? Who are we following today? Are we following Jesus Christ? Who are we following? 347-663-8638. If you want to add something to the conversation, feel free. 347-663-8638. We're talking about who we're following this morning. Who are we following? Are we following Jesus Christ? He said, He is the way, the truth, and the life. As we look in the mirror today, every man, every woman, every boy, every girl, if we're following the same Jesus, we all looking in the mirror and find out if our actions, our activities are in alignment. And if you're on the phone, you're not getting to right now, the phone is doing a download. So go ahead and call back. The phone is doing a download right now. 40 minutes after 11 o'clock. The time is moving really fast. Who are we following this morning? Who are we following? The Jesus that we talk about. As obedient children, he said, do not be conformed to the passions of your former ignorance. As he who called you is holy, you also be holy in all your conduct. I understand that pastors don't talk to pastors. Which God are you following? Who are you following then? Which Jesus? Hallelujah. 347-663-8638. If you're on the outside, talk to me. I think the phone is ready now. 347. As we all take a look in the mirror this morning. That's the number for the inside. When you call me, please turn off your radio so we can have a phone conversation. Who are we following? Who are you following? Who am I following? If you want to join the conversation in who are we following? Talking about the behavioral patterns of believers who claim to be following Jesus, the same Jesus who ask us to love our neighbor, love our brother. And you see, the thing about it, if a person is not willing to walk with you, then they're definitely different. But a person who is willing to walk with you, why are you not willing to walk with them? Hallelujah. Caller, get off. Good morning.
Hi, good morning. How are you doing?
I'm doing great in the name of Jesus.
I called because I was trying to call all the time, but now I get through.
Amen.
And I would like to share a message. This message to believers, for believers only, right? You are in the right school, in the right class, at the right time. Your teacher is Jesus Christ. Exam time is coming. You have to sit the exam. You cannot fail the exam because Jesus Christ is your teacher. After this exam, this is what you will hear. Come, he blessed of my Father. In heaven, this kingdom, I prepare for you from the beginning of this world. What I was listening to the other caller, the guy before.
Mm-hmm.
He was saying that when you go to churches, sometimes I pass the preacher, and you get up and walk. It could be that message. That message is for you. Understand?
Amen.
And sometimes we as a believer, it's not about religion, it's about having a relationship.
Hallelujah. And you see, caller, what you're saying, and in terms of what the caller mentioned of getting up and walking away. Now, you see, if you get up and walk away, how would the person know that they were saying something wrong? The Bible says, to whom much is given, much is required. Now, listen to here, he's saying that he's a pastor himself. Now, if you get up and walk away, then, you know, what happens? This person might be willing to hear from you. And this pastor might be willing to make his way better or fix himself or get himself right. But if you get up and walk away and just leave him in his ignorance, then what are you doing? You're not helping the body of Christ. Now, if you go to him and he's not willing to listen to you and he turn you away, now you're going to walk away because he give you a reason to walk away. You see what I'm saying?
Yes.
Amen. Thank you, my sister, in the name of Jesus.
You're welcome. Bye-bye.
Glory to God. All right. Joyce, good morning.
Good morning,
good morning, my brother. Yes, my brother, how are you doing?
Yes, I'm going to a banquet now still. But I was listening on the radio. But you said, follow me. I said, I follow Christ. So Christ tells me, follow me and I will make you fishers of men.
Amen.
Follow me and I will make you fishers. And I follow Christ. That is why, you know what I was saying, sir? Why we as church, we should come together and pray about this world crisis. I was looking at the TV and yesterday, you saw, they have war in Egypt and this. When I said the war, you know, remember, children die, you have women die, you have mother die. Is that sending food them, you know? They just take it to heart. And die. That's how we as church to come together, my friend, and pray about this world crisis that's going on.
Well, one thing we have to understand, when you're talking about world crisis, the Bible said there will be war and rumors of war. The word of God must come to fulfillment. We as Christians should pray that we'll be stronger and we'll be able to build up his kingdom and do what we got to do. But we have to also understand that his word will not return void. So things that happen in the world, they will happen. They have to happen. That's the way God said it, and they have to be done. So those things must happen. We, however, on the other side, have to pray for our Christian integrity and pray for our Christian brothers and sisters that they will be strengthened to continue to do and perform the duties that God has set us out to do. You know what I mean? But wars and rumors of wars, they're going to go on, because in the kingdom of darkness, they don't know better. They have no light. Amen. Thank you for the call, my brother.
I'm going to a banquet now.
Amen. Yes. All right. Love you in Jesus' name.
Yeah, man. In the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Glory to the Lord.
Yes.
All right.
Amen. 347-663-8638. This morning we're looking at the mirror. We're watching the mirror. We all say we believe in Christ, we believe in Jesus, but we have chosen not to deal with some of our so-called brethren who are looking for the same Jesus. Hallowed be your name, Father. You are worthy to be praised. 347-663-8638. Who are you following? Which Jesus are you following this morning? First John 2:3. And by this we know that we have come to know him. 347-663-8638. If you got a comment, don't be ashamed, don't be afraid to call. Who are you following this morning? Who are you walking with? The Bible says the meek shall inherit the earth. The man who is not ashamed to say, I'm sorry, I made a mistake, I apologize to you. Glory to the name of Jesus. Are you that person this morning? Or are you the person that certain people you would never forgive them? No, that was too bad. I would never forgive you. I would pay all the tithes. I will do whatever. But you, I would never forgive you. Are you that kind of person this morning? Who are you following? Which Jesus? Which kingdom are you hoping to inherit? With these kinds of attitude. Hey, caller, good morning to you.
Yeah, good morning.
Yes, morning, sir. How you doing?
This is the best program you ever have since listening on the radio. This is the best. And let me tell you, keep it up, man.
What make it the best?
All the wire. And this is the best program you ever have.
Why?
Because the program you used to have before, I was never interested in it.
When you said the program, what do you mean, the topic?
Yeah, like you used to have, like, I would say like about 4 or 5 months ago. I was never into it, but this program you have now, just, I listen to it, and I listen to what you say, and let me tell you, man, you're doing the best thing out there. Don't care what you say, you're doing the best.
To God be the glory. What can you add to the program? What can you add? What do you want to add?
Nothing really. It's just the program you have now. You know, it's way better than what you used to have before.
We understand and we thank God that we are able to increase.
Before, I never used to listen to the program.
Oh, you say you never used to listen, but if you don't listen, you cannot hear nothing if you don't listen. So...
No, before, when I hear that, I turn my radio off. I never used to listen to the program. But now I keep my radio off. Once it is on radio, I keep it off.
Amen. So, yeah.
I'm kind of busy now, so I have to go. Thank you.
All right. Thank you. Thank you, caller, for the call, indeed. All right. We appreciate it in the name of Jesus. 347-663-8638. Well, I guess it's... We thank you for the call, and if you're out there in Radio Land and you have something to share with the conversation, feel free to call and let your voice be heard, you know what I mean? Because, you know, overall we are not condemning anyone. I have my shortcomings as a believer in Christ, but you know one thing I know for sure, I'm willing to strive to make sure I don't get left behind with unforgiveness and all kind of pettiness. And this is what it's about this morning. Who are we following? This is what I want to know. This is what I want to know. Who are we following? We say we're following Jesus. Well, Jesus left some strict rules for us to follow. He left his identity, left his mark on who he is. And a lot of us in our actions, I want to know who we following this morning. Which Jesus are we following this morning? Who are we following? He said to just lift me up. And I will draw men unto me. And many of the things that we are doing, we are not lifting up Jesus. That is why men are not being drawn. And if they are drawn for one day, they're not going to stay. They're not going to stay because Jesus didn't draw them. You draw them by your hype and your antics. Well, antics are going to fade away. You need a new antics. It's just like a hit song. You come up with a song and everybody like it. Oh, Macarena. Macarena. Okay, whatever it is. After 2-3 days, then nobody want to hear it no more. And that is what it is. So when Jesus draw them, they're going to stay because the Holy Spirit is going to draw them and keep them. So this is what I'm saying. A lot of stuff that we are doing, we are not following Jesus. And that's really what it is. So we wanted to double check ourselves, look back in the mirror and find out who are we following this morning. Are you following? Who are you following? Hallelujah. Call of the morning.
I am a follower of Christ.
Amen.
I am an imitator of what Christ do. That's who I'm following.
Amen.
Christ. Yes. I want to do what he says to do. I'm trying to follow him the best I can. And I know I'm following Christ. Oh, yes.
Amen.
Said, be ye followers. Be brethren followers of me. If he didn't say me, he could have followed anybody. But he said, be ye followers of me.
Amen.
Christ. So we got to walk with him. We can, it's not a talking thing, it's an action thing.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
We got to do as he say, walk as he walk, because it's a Christ-like thing. It's a lifestyle.
Amen. Amen.
It's not an everyday talking conversation. It's an action thing.
Amen. Amen.
So, my brother, I feel good walking with Christ.
Amen.
I've been stripped a lot of things, but I love who I am today.
In Jesus' name.
Because of who I follow.
Amen.
Mm-hmm. Amen. I love it. I love it.
Thank you, my sister, in Jesus' name.
Yes, 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 yes. He's great. I'm not following no church, no pastor, because they could change. God don't change.
Amen. Well, we have to respect the pastors because you have chosen pastors, apostles, teachers, preachers in different capacities. Yeah. But you know, your focus is on the Word of God, and if they are walking in alignment with God,
then like you and I, they just have a plate and something saying who they are, but they still could make mistakes.
Amen.
They still could lead the flocks astray. But Jesus,
hallelujah.
Oh my God, He said He is the same yesterday, today, and forever.
Amen. And that one thing that you said there, you know, a lot of us who's walking in different churches and whatever it is, even if we see the wrong being perpetrated, as much as we know the Word of God, we are not standing up and say that this is not the Word of God. And you see, all this is why we say, we question, who are you following? Because if you're following Jesus and you see something from the head that does not relate to Jesus, it's your duty to say, hey, could I talk to you for a minute?
Exactly.
Can I talk to you tomorrow? When are you available? You know, Pastor, I saw this, or I noticed this, I heard this, and to me, it didn't relate to my spirit. How can we fix this? How can we rectify the situation? That is our duty as believers in Christ. That is what we're supposed to do. Because sometimes the man of God has opened up himself to allow the enemy to come in. So now he's saying Jesus, but Jesus is not within him. And he's not even aware. So we, on the other hand, has to be our brother's keeper. You understand me? If we see something, our duty is to pray for them and also make them aware of what you are noticing. You understand me? Because sometimes a person feel that they've gone so far, they cannot come back. They cannot be fixed. They cannot be repaired. Yeah. But if you let them know, look, because there are times when I pick up the phone and I call certain people, certain pastors, and the Spirit tell me to pray for them. And I just say, okay, Pastor, let us just pray right now. In the name of Jesus. And we finish praying. And when I finish praying for them, they will say, oh God, 007, you don't know how much I needed this. You don't know how much I needed this. Because the man of God need to also be strengthened. He need to be strengthened by other people to call and touch and agree and empower them. So a lot of us, we are not doing what we are supposed to do if we are following Christ. Because Christ asked us to do these things. You understand me? Mm-hmm. Amen, my sister. Thank you very much.
Yes.
Glory to God.
Glory to God.
Amen.
Amen.
Hey, caller, good morning. You're next.
Hi, good morning, brother.
Good morning, my sister. How are you doing in the name of Jesus?
I'm enjoying the service. It's so good.
Hallelujah.
You know, I call about the sister. You know, she's so right that she's talking about following Jesus and not following the pastor. Because sometimes you can talk to the pastor and say, well, look, what you're saying is not right. And next thing they go about saying you have demons on you. You can't tell the pastor that and... You know, so when you follow Jesus, you can't go wrong, because he promised us. He said to seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all things shall added unto us.
Amen, indeed.
You know? When you follow Jesus, remember he's the Son of God. You can't go wrong.
Amen, you know? Amen. This is not to put down the pastor, you know, because
I'm doing the right thing.
Yes, I'm making the statement so that pastors don't feel that we are trying to incite a riot or invite negative or criticism to them and what they are trying to do. So, you know, people take things all kind of different way. But the point is, if based on what the Bible asks us to do, to be humble as a child. You understand me? If a pastor is so pumped up even in himself and he won't be able to humble, he will have a problem. But the point is, God is always showing us that I'm here with you. I'm here for you. If you're following me, I will show you what you need to see. I will make you know what you need to know. But then, therefore, you have to act according to what I've shown you. And I'm saying to you, the body of Christ, many people see what they see, know what they know they walk in Christ, but they are refusing to act on what God has shown them. And this is such a defeat, because this Holy Spirit lead you to all truth. And if he show you something, it's because he's trying to tell you, this is what you need to do. You are in me. Forget about who say they're in me. Because on that day, many will say, Lord, Lord. And I will say, I don't know them. But it doesn't mean that he don't know you.
Amen.
So you have to know who you are in Christ. And this is something that we always say. You have to know who you are in Christ. Because the man you're looking at, talking all the bunch of 95 words a minute, and all the scripture verse, he don't have to be in Christ. So you don't look at the physical. And that's when you talk about the physical and the spiritual. If you watching the spiritual and you are more impressed by the physical appearance and all the talk and the bunch of rah rah rah, then you are falling away from the spirit, because the spirit has nothing to do with the flesh. You see what I'm saying? But there are many times we get caught up in the flesh and we are impressed by the words or the many words spoken. You understand me?
Yeah.
I'm talking about many words spoken, but zero action is complementing the words that is spoken. In other words, a man is talking all the God, but every single action and activity of him do not relate to the word which he speaketh. You see what
That's
I'm saying?
So true.
And as much as God has shown you the light and you see what it is, you refuse to move and continue to walk the path. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you for the call, my sister, in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
12 o'clock and the phone is still open, because, you know, it's an important conversation that we're going to do here today. We're asking, who are we following? And we're saying this because each and every one of us have the potential to make mistakes. We have the potential to fall off, to go out of line. But we must recheck our actions, our activities, what we say, what we do, and see if it lines up to following Jesus, the Lord, Jesus Christ. That's all I'm saying today. We're not criticizing, we're not condemning, because we all are capable of failing. But overall, if we are following Jesus, we would be willing to maintain the walk with what he recommended. Like I said, there are many religions and different people that do not, they're not in common with other people, and they therefore, because they're not in the same, you know, belief system, they resent them. They don't talk to them. They don't deal with them. I don't know which God you're serving. This morning we're just reaching out to you and asking you to come back on the trail of Jesus. Because Jesus never said that. You see, if a man say he don't want Jesus, that's a different story. But if a man say he want Jesus, but he might be going the wrong way, Jesus never tell you to stop talking to him or don't deal with him. No. Hallelujah. He might be going the same direction you going, but he going on the wrong vehicle. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hey, caller, good morning.
Good morning, my brother.
Morning, my sister. How are you doing?
Oh, let's give thanks and praise on to the Lord, for
Hallelujah.
He is good.
Yes.
And his mercy endure forever.
Hallowed be your name, Jesus.
I am so thankful that God is the head of my life this morning.
Amen, my sister.
Because if he wasn't, I wouldn't be here today. I have so much to be thankful to God for. And brothers and sisters, these are perilous days. And we got to get closer to Almighty God. We got to forget what everybody else is saying and get close to God. We got to read our Bibles and ask him to give us wisdom and understanding to understand what we read. Sometimes a lot of us, we make our pastors our God. And he's not our God. He's a human being just like us. He's ordained by God, and he's there to help guide us. But we have to get into our Bible and know God's word for ourselves. Hallelujah. So that when he is teaching and he's talking, we can identify with what he's saying, or if he's not saying what is right. We don't want to go and have an argument with him, but we got to pray for him. This world needs a lot of prayer. Pastors needs a lot of prayer. The leaders need prayer. We all need prayer, because we all have sinned and come short of
the glory
of
Hallelujah.
God.
Jesus.
None of us are perfect.
Amen.
No, not one of us.
Hallelujah.
And sometimes one person interprets something one way, somebody else see it another way. But as believers and children of God, we should be able to come together and sit down and reason together and
Hallelujah.
Discuss it in love.
In love, yes.
Because none of us are perfect.
Hallelujah,
and we
Jesus.
All see things in a different way.
Hallelujah.
But if it is about God, we should be able to talk about it.
We should be
you
able to talk about it.
You might know a little more
it.
Than I know.
Yes.
And I might have a little something that you don't have. We come together, we add it in, and we spice it up, and we teach each other.
Hallelujah.
That's what we're supposed to be doing.
Hallelujah.
But we get away from that. We're there. We try to tear each other down. And brother, sometimes the people that are tearing you down, brother, is those same people who are supposed to be believers.
Hallelujah.
They tear you down. It brings tears to my eyes right now as I speak, because a lot of it is happening in the churches.
Hallelujah.
The people who are supposed to be there to help lift you up, they
Amen.
Tear you
Amen.
Down.
Amen. But my
and
sister.
And then we criticize the people that are out in the world.
Amen. But my sister.
But sometimes they do better than we as believers do.
Hallelujah.
And it is so sad, because then we want to tell them, you need to come to church, you need to serve God. But then when they look at our lives, you know what they're saying? Why should I do that? Look at you. Look at the way you're living. You're saying one thing with your lips, but your walk is not the right walk.
Amen. Hallelujah.
So we have to be careful of the things we say
Amen.
And the things we do.
Amen.
And we got to get our souls ready, because we don't know. Look what is happening today in this world. Our young people, we're killing out our own generation. Every day you turn your radio on, they shoot, 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 shoot. And I say, my God, I pray for the parents. What happened to the parents? I know some of us are doing the best that we can, but there's some of us who are doing nothing. We're just letting our children just go wild and causing pain upon family after family. But we got to get into the Word of God, read God's Word, and give our lives over to God, because there's nothing else. We've
Amen.
Done everything else on our own way, and we realize that without Him, we will fall.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
We can't even walk without Him holding our hands.
Hallowed be your name,
we need
Jesus.
Him. He's our
yes.
very present help in the time of trouble.
Hallelujah.
And He wants us to call upon His name.
Yes.
And He will hear and answer us.
Yes.
But we've got to get our souls right. We want to argue
Amen.
Too much.
Amen.
We want to have all these bad feelings, all this envy, all this hatred towards one another. God has given each and every one of us a talent, and we need to use it. He didn't give me the same talent that He gave you, double O. He didn't do that. We all are different, but we all should be able to come together as the body of Christ and lift up the name of Jesus,
that He can
and
draw.
Go there in souls
yes.
and pray for the weak and
Hallelujah.
Pray for the suffering and pray for the dying. That's
Amen.
What God wants us
That's
to
what he
do
wants.
As a people.
Hallelujah.
So I encourage you today, my brother.
Amen.
Keep
Glory
up the
to
good
the name
work
of
that
Jesus.
You're doing.
Hallowed
Keep
be your
up
name.
The good work. You've lifted my spirit
Glory
many times. Many times
Jesus.
That I might be down and out, and I turn that
Hallelujah.
Radio on. Even if it is not you, it's
Glory.
Someone else on your program
yes.
that says something to lift my spirit and to keep me believing and to know that God hasn't forgotten about me, that He's working on my situation right as we speak. So you keep it, keep doing good, my brother. I pray that God will bless you. I pray that God will keep you. I pray for strength for you today. I pray for more wisdom and understanding for you as you lead God's people. And yes, hallelujah, that He will watch over you and your family and everyone that you bring up here that is of one accord with you, brother. Listen, you're going to have the names there. They're there. But you keep doing, you keep digging and digging and digging and digging deeper into the Word of God, that you can stand firm with whatever you say to God's people on your radio. So God bless you, my brother, and may He keep you, and may He wash over you, and may He prosper you, and that everything that you touch, that it will prosper. God bless, and you have a great day. Oh, hallelujah. We thank you. We thank you, Father, for your people. We thank you. We thank you. For the ones that are trying to walk in your will and to do the right things, because there's so many false prophets out there. But we thank you this morning. We thank you. We plead the blood of Jesus upon this radio station this morning. And against everything, every principality, every stronghold in the mighty name of Jesus this morning. Satan, take your hands off this radio station. that it can bring your word to the lost and comfort those who are suffering and mourning out there and who are crying out because their souls are so lost and they don't know what to do or where to turn. But thank you, Jesus, that you can turn that dial and their words of encouragement that come from your man of God and your men of God and women of God who comes on this station day after day. So we give you thanks today, Father. We give you thanks. We give you praise. We give you honor. We give you glory because you are worthy of all praise, honor, and glory this morning in the mighty name of Jesus. And I say thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. So peace be unto you, my brother.
Yes, my sister, in the name of Jesus. Thank you for your contribution.
Okay, have a blessed day. Yes. Bye-bye.
Hallelujah, Jesus, you're worthy. 9 minutes on the other side of the hour, indeed. Hey, caller, good morning, you're next.
Hey, good morning, Doblo. This is Brother Michael Prince, man. What's good?
Yes, brother, yes, hallelujah. Glory to the name.
Praise the Lord, man. God is good.
Yes, he is.
All the time, man, all the time. Yeah, I was listening to the conversation there. One of the things that I hear people keep saying all the time, you know, and this is not a criticism, because the whole thing about Christianity is not about criticism, but we should be able to correct and edify one another so that we should all grow in the knowledge and in the wisdom of God.
Hallelujah. And this is really what we're trying to get across, you know what I mean? And because that's
definitely
why the conversation is, who are you following? Because you see, you could say you have the word right. You could feel that you have everything right. Nothing wrong with that. But when you turn around and the people who don't believe in what you believe, you decide to cut them off and shut them off. Although they tell you, and in all the actions and activity, they show you that, look, brother, I'm looking for the same building that you're looking for. I'm looking for the same address that you are going. I might be walking on the wrong street, but I'm looking for the same address that you're looking for, my brother. And you decide to cut me off and don't go with me, don't walk with me, then this is not Jesus. This is not God, and this is what we're trying to say. This is why we want people to come off of religion. There are many times people are so caught up in religion that they cannot see the light of the Holy Spirit. And I will tell you a testimony that happened. You know, we used to have this program on the radio called Word of God Speak, and we used to have them on the radio for over a year. They've been on Choice Radio, and I listen to them all the time. They come on the radio and they talk a lot of things that are logical. Everything that they speak from the Bible, they make sense. They are logical to the ears of anyone with wisdom. They are logically sound. However, one night I heard them talking about the Holy Spirit and speaking in unknown tongues. Not speaking in tongues. Speaking in an unknown tongue, which is in Corinthians. And the people were trying to say that the speaking in unknown tongues is in same relation to speaking in tongues as in other language. And when I heard them say that, I called and I say, brother, you know, the Bible is the Bible, you know, and the Bible is the Word of God. And if you believe in one area of the Bible, why are you having a hard time to accept another part of the Bible? It doesn't really make sense. And he was trying to explain to me. I said, well, look, even if you don't understand it in your little brain, if God say it is, then it is. You are not God. If God say there's an unknown tongue, well, that's what it is. It's an unknown tongue. So guess what happened? I said, my brother, I need to speak to you. We need to sit down and reason together. So we had a meeting, and he came with his Bible, and I came with my Bible, and we sat and I held his hand together. And we say, Father, in the name of Jesus, as we are about to reason about your word, Father, in the name of Jesus, I am willing to go over to my brother's side if the Holy Spirit convicts me in your word that what he is saying is the truth. And my brother, I am hope that he is willing to come over to my side if what I got from the revelation it's true and he agreed to what was said. However, we started reading the same scripture from the same version of the Bible together. And the scripture clearly states, a man who speaks in an unknown tongue edifieth himself. He speaketh not unto man, but unto God. We stopped right there and I said, what does it say to you? He asked me if I know what unknown mean. I said, my brother, you never questioned no other part where unknown was used in the Bible. You never questioned the context on which it was written in no other area of the Bible. Why are you now questioning the context or the meaning of the word in definition in that area of the scripture? How dare exactly. you? Because if you had a problem with unknown in any other part of the Bible, then you would bring up the meaning in Greek and the other meanings of the word in those areas, because you are trying to show that the meaning is established here and the meaning therefore is the same here. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah, as for double O, it's yes. not hard enough. It's not hard. You can see when somebody have a religious agenda.
Hallelujah.
The Bible means what it says.
And it says, and it what,
says
it mean.
What it means. Now watch this. In 1 Corinthians chapter, I think it's 12 and verse
12, somewhere yes, there, yes.
It says that we all are baptized into one spirit. So in other words, if you are a true believer, I'm a true believer seeking the same thing, we will identify with each other.
We should.
But once there is division, and the scripture is presented in front of you, and it is logical, it is clear, and you want to come up with your own interpretation, you are on a religious agenda.
Hallelujah. Because, my brother, let me tell you something. I was on one time, you know, I really and truly, when I listen to the logics of God being an unchanging God, you understand me? I said, well, if God said this, the Sabbath should be looked at a certain way and whatever, I say, well, of course, the Sabbath must be the Sabbath, because if God never changed, those things never change. So I came on one Saturday and we was discussing the Sabbath, and many people call, a lot of people, a lot of different voices I heard call and was saying, yes, my brother, no, because I guess they are Sabbath keepers, and they called and they were talking about it. But as I continue to look into it and really try to get more information on how valid this is, the spirit continue to transgress against me. It's like, you know, what are you doing? I set you free in liberty in Galatians 5:1. I set you free, stand still. I set you free, stand firm in the liberty to which Christ had made you free. I set you free. Why are you trying to put yourself in bondage? And so now, while I was researching on this the Sabbath thing, the more I keep going deeper in it, is the more my spirit continue to feel like just confused. Sometimes I came on the radio and I couldn't even function right, because, you know, I'm really looking into this thing. And I can remember one time, as a confirmation, Patricia Greenwood came on after I was coming on the radio, and I was operating the board for her, and she was doing her ministry. And she came on that night, and she said, the word she had that night was, why are you battling two opinions? Why are you doing this? The Lord has set you free. Why are you doing this? And it was a confirmation to me that, you know, this was something I shouldn't really get involved in, because I was already free. The thing about it is, I received Christ without following no Sabbath. And I was having joy in my soul and in my spirit while I wasn't doing no Sabbath. So I know that this Holy Spirit is with me. Because when I found Christ, I didn't find him with doing no Sabbath. And when there was nothing about the Sabbath that was involved in me being saved or me finding Christ. You see what I'm saying? But no, I was going to start to indoctrinate this into my salvation. And therefore, Hallelujah, go ahead.
Yeah, you see, my brother, the problem is not the Sabbath, you know, is man understanding of Scripture.
Hallelujah. And not even that too. But it is the legalistic state of
exactly.
the Sabbath.
And that's why Paul had to warn them in Galatians 3 and call them, oh foolish Galatians, who have bewitched you. You understand? You continue in the spirit, but now you think by the effort of your flesh energy, you can keep God's rules and be with God. But we are set free in Christ. And so Christ
exactly.
has fulfilled all the agenda that God determines for us to be right. And
hello.
None of us, by keeping rules and legalistic regulation, can please God.
Exactly, because guess what? Not to cut you, but if those things was good enough to be saved before Jesus, then what was the reason for Jesus?
Exactly.
There would be no reason for Jesus if what you were doing and the way you're pretending to be holy on one day and the rest of the week you don't talk to nobody, if this was good enough to receive the Holy Spirit and to walk with Jesus, then there was no reason for Jesus. And then the thing about it is, you cannot be in two opinions. You cannot follow Jesus and believe that Jesus paid ALL, which means all, but still feel you have to do 10% of it or 20%, and this is the whole concept of the whole thing, and they don't understand.
Sorry, my brother, but I just said that there. Don't you know that the scripture said, I think it's Colossians chapter 2 and verse 10, that we are complete in Christ?
Hallelujah!
Do you know what that means? That every requirement of God has fulfilled in Christ.
In Jesus
so
Christ.
Christ has infused his righteousness in us. We are complete in him. There is no rules and legalistic regulation we have to do. The work that is being done, it has been done by Christ. When Christ bled and died on the cross, he said, it is finished.
Everything.
All the requirements that God needed, it is fulfilled in Christ.
In Christ.
This is what folks don't realize. This is why they're setting up all this agenda and
Amen.
All these legalistic things.
And not to cut you, I know you're hot, and I am so hot too, because you know different revelation just coming to me at the same time. You know, sometimes I question the Holy Spirit when I read certain scriptures, and I was trying to, you know, ask, you know, for a revelation that I can relate in my own words to my own people as to the Old Testament and the New Testament. And what the Spirit clearly just illustrated in my spirit is that the Old Testament situation was like a physical situation. It's like back in the days with the old time telephone, you're going to make a call, right? You physically have the receiver in your hand, and the wire connects physically from the receiver to the box. The box connects to the wall connects to the wire on the pole connects to another pole down the street, and then go into a neighbor house, and then go to the same phone. So now, by physically looking at the connection that is completely made, you make the call, and with confidence in the connection which you can physically see, you know that the next person should answer on the other line. However, in the New Testament, because it's a spiritual thing, you pick up your cell phone, you dial on the keypad, you don't see the connection, but you know for sure, through faith in the line that is made between the connection that you cannot see, you're going to speak to your parents back in the islands. You see what I'm saying?
Right.
So this is why now in the New Testament, we are dealing through faith in Jesus Christ. So it's not a physical application no more. There is nothing physical you and I have to do. You understand me? That's why
exactly.
Even when...
Yes. And in the book of Romans, Paul make it clear. He said, no man is justified. No man, nobody, no one at all is justified by the deeds of the law. What is the deeds of the law? Doing things, ceremonial things, keeping rules, keeping days, you know, and checking time and season and all this stuff. No one is justified by that. But we are justified in Christ. In Christ,
in
and
Christ,
in
alone.
Christ alone.
Yes. So listen, and you see, my brother, listen to me. My mind is so open, and God know my heart. I came off the street as a man on the street. We used to be jumping and guying on and stuff. And Jesus saved me. You think Jesus saved me to come and confuse me with his word? No. He
exactly.
saved me to save me, and I know I'm saved in Jesus Christ. I know I'm saved. Every day I try to perfect my walk with him in the spirit, but I know I'm saved. But now, because I'm trying...
Listen, my brother, it's a spiritual thing, and I know it because I identify with you. Spirit identify with spirit. Now, the things that you do in practice, now you are living in following Christ. In other words, you are living righteously now, not that your living is something that you're doing to keep yourself safe, but as a result of being saved, you want to live right to please God.
Hallelujah. In the spirit.
In the spirit.
Yes.
It's called sanctification.
Yes.
You understand? But a lot of people are confused. They think that by trying to do good and trying to keep rules and regulation is as same as being saved or are trying to ascribe to salvation.
Yeah, but you see, my
and
brother.
The problem, go ahead.
I don't think it's that really to say that they, you know, you see, when you are indoctrinated into something, you know, it's kind of hard, because I feel if you just accept Christ, just Jesus come into my life, you've never been in no religion, and Jesus come into your life like this, you are more free to just get into the more spiritual aspect of Christ and understanding how Christ is completed in you and you are completed in Christ. Unless you start going to certain churches where they preach about the Sabbath and different things that they tell you got to do. Now you trying to do what they are telling you along with your Christian with your salvation. So while you're doing that now, you are tying two things into one.
Exactly.
So the Spirit is not able to lead you and confirm to you which is what is right and what is wrong, because you are giving emphasis to both sides of the fence. You are giving emphasis to what is being taught to you while the Spirit is trying to tell you. So now you are in between two decisions. You don't know which one to believe, because these people who come to you as educated is telling you that this is the way it is done. And you are giving them credit because of their much education and much words and much scripture that they know. And it's the same thing with the Pharisees. The Pharisees knew the scripture back in the days. They knew the scripture. They knew what this word said. They were able to quote every line for you, line by line, precept by precept. They knew it. But they still didn't understand the Spirit of Christ. They didn't want that.
Because you know why, my brother, I want to continue? They did not have a relationship with God. And that's what makes the difference. Because I think it's in Romans chapter 6, he said, those that are the sons of God are led by the Spirit of God. In other words, God, by His Spirit, will lead you into all truth. I think it's in 1 John chapter 2 and verse 27 down there. He says, do not let anyone deceive you, because you have the anointing from above, and it tells the truth, and it's no lie in it. So now when you go to a teacher or a pastor or a preacher or whoever, if they are not bringing forth the truth, your spirit will be troubled. Your spirit will be grieved. And now you have to go back to the Word and learn the truth. That's why I heard a sister say that you got to study to show yourself approved. You got
to unto God. Unto God. To show
and
you.
Listen, my brother.
To prove unto God. To prove unto God. That's something we keep me to you. Show yourself approved to be unto God, not unto
exactly,
man.
Exactly. Exactly. And a point I was making, my brother. Listen. When it comes for the Word of God says one thing. Just like how Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. That's one statement. Now, you and I, in living our practical Christian life, we might have what you call
revelation.
Opinions of certain things. Mm. But when it comes for principles, the principles should be
the
one
same.
As
Hallelujah.
Glorifying God.
Amen.
On preferences,
Amen.
On preferences, my brother, that's the word I want to use. On preferences, we can be different. Like, for example, you don't like green, and I like red, and so forth. You understand? On these little minor things, we can be different. But when it comes for principle, the standard of the word
Hallelujah.
Of God, there should be no difference.
Amen.
Because listen what Paul said, that we should have the same mind. If at the end of my conversation, we cannot agree, and we cannot walk the same road, then there's a dead monkey on the line somewhere. Brother.
Exactly.
Somebody's
exactly.
Religion.
That's why I related to when they hold on the day of Pentecost. Only when they were in one accord, the Holy Spirit were able to come. You see what I'm saying? Only when they were in one accord, the Holy Spirit were able
exactly.
to do what it's supposed to do. They had to be in one accord. So now I'm saying to you now, when people don't want to talk to you and they don't want to deal with you because you don't believe in what they believe, who are you following?
Exactly.
Who are you really following? We must find out who you following, because the thing about it is, I could understand if a person do not believe in religion, they don't believe in Jesus, they don't believe in Christ, they don't believe in being saved, I could understand, well, you could take the high road and you don't cast your pearl on swine, you understand me? But the point
exactly.
is, if the person tell you that I am following Jesus, I love Jesus, I love the Lord, I'm doing whatever. No, they might not have certain things that you have, but the point is, they are not telling you they don't want your Jesus. So if they want your Jesus, why you don't want to talk to them?
Exactly. Well, not the same Jesus we're talking about.
No,
it's
Jesus. Well, I'm trying to tell you, this is what it's supposed to be. That's why the conversation today is what it is. Because there are a lot of people who say we walk in the same road, going to the same Jesus, but there are things that Jesus told us that we make up in our mind we don't want to do. So which Jesus are you following?
Exactly.
Are you following your emotions?
That love is the fulfillment of the law.
Hallelujah.
If me and you have, we see certain things when it comes to preferences in a different line. At the end of the road, we have to shake hands or hug and say goodbye, my brother, with a loving spirit. Even though we don't see some things not in principle, but in preferences. You understand? We still have to walk together because we are one in Christ. Because God said, how can you say you love God and hate your brother? And have grievance towards your brother. It just does not work.
And this is the basic fundamental principle of being a child of God. And I was saying to Bishop Anderson today, I was saying, look, something that a lot of Christians are not willing to adhere to or to accept as a reality of life is that the Bible said, look, feed my sheep. Now, he didn't tell you when you feed them, they should grow 10 pounds every week.
know.
Because some will grow 10 pounds and some would never grow. But he never tell you to don't feed them. He said to just feed them. All you have to do is feed them. Feed them the word, feed them information, feed them with food, do whatever, feed them. But you see, the thing about it is a lot of us are not willing to accept that not everybody is going to make it. Because everybody's preference is different. And everybody have different things in life that don't care what you do. You could tell them the truth as much as you want. They have their own personality and they're going to choose what they want to choose. And we have to be willing to see that if all Christians are not going to do the right thing, you don't have to fall apart because a Christian or somebody you look up to didn't live up to what they were supposed to or what they say. And many times in life, this is one of our biggest downfall as believers. We say we are following Christ, but when somebody who is supposed to be following Christ fall off, we lose the focus on Christ. You see what I'm saying? That's what I'm trying to say. We have to be strong in Christ enough that if somebody who we look up to, whatever what it is, fall off, we should not fail and faint and fall off and say we don't want to go to church no more because this person said this to me, this person do this to me, the pastor don't like me. Or No. This has nothing to do with nothing.
A thought come to me right now. You see this thing about following people and rejecting God because of other people? That's the wrong concept. Couple callers said before about Jesus is the one that we should look onto. And that's the key, because that's what the Bible said in Hebrews chapter 12, coming down there. It said, looking unto Jesus, who is the author and the finisher. And the finisher of our faith. Is he we got to look to, Jesus and Jesus alone. Of course, as brothers and sisters in the Lord, we got to cooperate, we got to help one another. We are not independent. But if you go to look at man, man will always fall. But Jesus never fall. He is the perfect one. That's why we put our trust in him and him alone. So those who want to behave in another way and do not want to take heed to the word of God, the Bible says the wheat and the tares going to grow together. But we don't have to pull them out. We got to leave them there and we got to rebuke the spirit, because the Bible says we are to contend for the faith. When we see ignorant things happening around us and people speaking all kind of different things, we got to stop and say, no brother, no sister, this is not a way. No, if they don't want to listen, it's up to them.
But you cannot walk away from them.
Go ahead, man.
I'm just saying that you shouldn't walk away from them. And this is what we're trying to say today. A lot of people do not want to deal with you just because you don't believe in what they believe or you don't want to go with what they're saying. They stop talk to you. They stop deal with you. So I want to know, who are you following? Because who are you following?
Exactly. So the conclusion of the matter, simply, my brother, at the end of the day, if I'm a brother, you're a sister, or brothers and sisters in Christ, we have to agree in love at the end of the day, regardless to how our different preferences are. That's the final agenda. You understand? We have to agree. We have to work together, all right, at the end of the day, to bring glory and honor
to the name of Jesus. And that's why, and something I said before, when we opened the forum here on the radio, a person told me one time, oh, 007, if it's not going your way, you don't like it. But I'm saying to you, we're looking to be able to edify each other, that we can lift up the name of Jesus. So if you call in with a different agenda, or you call in, because there are listeners who will listen to the radio, you know, religiously every day, and all they're listening for, as much as they say they are a follower of Christ, they're listening for error. They listen to hear you say something that doesn't line up with the word, to say, you hear him? No, instead of they will call and say, my brother, I heard you said this, but it's actually this. Or I think you should read this here and see what it says. You know, they will listen just to hear criticism. But this is what we do as human beings. This is the thing that we are capable of. You see what I'm saying? So I'm saying, if when you call and you're not trying to, that we could, you don't have to agree with what I'm saying, but if what you're saying is to help to better what I'm saying, or to make it even more profound, or to make it more that everybody could understand it, or we can in the end come to the same conclusion in terms of lifting up the gospel or the truth of God, then that's what it's about. But if every time we have a topic, you're going to call and go contrary to what is being said, then if we don't work in together, then we have a problem.
Yeah, my brother. And so one of the things that I see a lot of people say, and we should never ever say these things, is that scripture have different interpretation. What might be interpreted to you might be interpreted to me. No, the Bible is one.
Is one.
You understand?
All
now,
the way.
Listen, listen, and God is one. Now listen. Now in your reading, you may not come to that understanding yet,
of the passage of scripture that you're reading. But you got to keep searching and keep digging and take it from context, line upon line, precept upon precept. Because believe me, if at the end of the day you say, okay, I see it that way, and you see it that way, you're talking about scripture, principles of God, you interpret it another way, and I interpret it another way, there must be confusion.
And not even that too. With most people who come from a religious state of mind in their reading of the Bible or understanding, they will have a little problem really getting to the real, real facets of revelation in terms of the spiritual contents of the Bible, because something will be holding them back from accepting something that they once believed was not so. You see what I'm saying? That's why the Bible asks you to remove self. Remove self. Remove to all that you previously learned and allow the Spirit to lead you into all truth. So if your intention is pure and you just love the Lord, guess what? The Lord will talk to you. He's not no respecter of person. He will let you know that you are in the truth and your spirit is going to relate to it in the truth.
Exactly.
You see
what
I'm saying?
That's what the Bible says.
Amen.
Yeah, that's what the scripture says, that God will communicate to his children. Those that are the sons of God will be led by the Spirit of God. That's what happened. That's why, my brother, that I am convinced that you are a child of God, because you have been led by the Spirit of God. There will be times when you, have to grow and grow more and more because you just start. But I can hear the passion. I can connect with your spirit. Not because me and you is friend, but I know when something is real. You understand? Because I have the Spirit of God. I know where I was to, just like how you testify. And I know the things that I liked. But God has done something in my life.
Hallelujah. That's why we keep saying, new believers are not, like in 1 Timothy, you got to know who you are in Christ. It doesn't make a difference what nobody try to paint you as or make you look like. You have to know that you have a part to play in the kingdom. And you don't have to let nobody belittle you because you are young in the things of God. But you have to know that you have a power and you have something about you that nobody cannot tell you. And this is what God put in every one of us. That don't care what nobody want to tell you or make you feel, or they might not choose you for something in the church. And something that is destroying congregation and churches right now, physical churches building, is that people are put in position because of how much money they give to you and how much what car they drive and this kind of nonsense. And this is destroying the kingdom of God, because people are not, hallelujah, it's not in the spirit. So the Spirit of God cannot operate, because the unison in the spirit is not in there, in the body, in the administrative area of the body. You understand me? People put in position because they look tall, they look slim, they look a certain way, or they have a certain whatever about them. What is this about?
Glorification, my brother. It's all about people trying to market stuff and get rich, you know, and so they're using all kind of strategies and techniques. But the Bible tells us that the Spirit of God will connect to the Spirit of God, to the children of God, in knowing and in discerning that which is of God and which is not of God. You got to know, you got to discern, you got to learn, you got to see and identify. But a lot of people are easily caught up in the hype and they want to go with the flow and so forth. But it's not about going with the flow. It's walking in righteousness, in walking in the way of the Lord and understanding what God has called us for. To lift up his name, to praise his name.
That he can draw men. That he can draw men.
All the things that we desire, all the things that we're asking God for, it will just flow. You understand? It will just flow.
Of course, man.
But a lot of people, when they're chasing after that, they have to come with all kind of religious schemes, kind of a tradition, and all kind of schemes, and all kind of regulation, and ceremony, and say, well, that's the way, and this is how the way we got to do it, and so you're going to get your blessing and so forth. But that's not the way.
And guess what, my brother, what you're saying there, look, we know a lot of people not going to like what we're saying, but you know what happened? We are the remnant. We
exactly.
are the remnant, because God realized that, look, he had to raise up a people that is not going to shade around. Listen to me. If you read the scripture talking about your father owned the cattle on a thousand hills, why do you go around begging and making yourself look like you have to beg? Every
exactly.
time, there are some churches, all the whole calendar already full out with how many prayer breakfasts for the year. Go and feed the poor. You feed the people. Bring all your money together. Let's go feed the poor and see how much money God is going to pour into your ministry.
Mm-hmm.
God have people out there waiting to give you millions if you are doing what he tell you to do. You don't have to go begging, and every time you have to put on something.
My brother.
Come on,
Eve,
man.
give, here the scripture says, give and it shall be given unto you.
Hallelujah.
The scripture didn't say, I'm going to give you first and then give, you know. It said, give and it shall be given unto you.
Amen.
That's what the word of God says.
Well, this is the basic. This is the basic fundamental of the scripture, and this is why you are not seeing the prosperity in a lot of the churches. And they're trying to, you know, everybody, you know, some little shacking up here, shacking up there, shacking up there. God is to be glorified as the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, and God is to supply all your needs according to your riches in glory if you're doing what He asks you to do. And many preachers are not satisfied to be on the corner giving out tracts. No. They want a building right away because they went to some place and they learned something about the Bible, and they want to be in control of the money the same way that the previous pastor was. So everybody want to control their own money and have their own finance. As a matter of fact, some people want to do all by themselves. They don't even want to put people in positions that they will administrate in. So this is why the kingdom of God is not being seen. You're not seeing miracles being performed. You're not seeing the manifestation. But Jesus is right here waiting for us to do what He asks us to do. Just lift me up and I will draw men. Let me tell you something. You can come on the radio and just do half an hour talking about the goodness of the Lord. Just Jesus and talking about Jesus. And without you not giving your phone number or nothing, people will be looking for you. People could be trying to find you to do things for you because you lift up the name of Jesus. And they don't understand the principle. And that's why I say, many people read the Bible, but are you doing the scripture? Because all He said to just lift me up and I will draw men. You don't have to draw nobody. Just lift me up. It's like, the way I see it is like God is behind the fence. People cannot see Him over there. Raise Him up that people could see Him over there. I want to say, oh, look at Him. Oh, look. And they will look at Him and be drawn by what they see in Him just by the way you lift Him up. But men keep lifting up themselves. They're lifting up their building. They're lifting up their church. They're lifting up their function. They're lifting up all this thing and nothing about Jesus. Getting people depressed, getting people to just turn off because they are not bringing Jesus. If you bring Jesus enough, Jesus is going to supply all your needs according to His riches in glory when He's ready to do it. But some people, we want it now. We want a big building. You have 20 members with a little small church. You cannot even take care of these 20 members, but you want to open one with 1,000. So you're not seeing more chaos you're looking to cause. And that is what's going on in the body of Christ. Hallelujah.
Listen to this, my brother. I mean, I'm not criticizing everybody, but you can see it happening, eh? Because the church, listen, the church is the church. God's church will stand, all right? But there are a lot of little buildings, a lot of little groups in corner, and one of the things you will find them doing, are you listening, my brother? Yeah, one of the things you will find them doing in a lot of these little buildings and groups and church and so forth is that, you know, the service doesn't even, it just starts a few seconds. They sing a couple songs and then let's pick up the offering. You understand? It's all about prosperity. It's all about trying to have the best church. It's all about trying to, you know, be this mega pastor. No, how about glorifying Jesus? How about lifting up Jesus with the 6 members you have? I'm forgetting about that 2,000 and so forth.
Well, that is all He asks, you know. That's all He asks. And if we could be in more unison and submit and serve each other, it will be better off. Because every person, before they feel they have a little anointing, they want their own church.
Exactly.
Nobody willing to submit themselves to nobody no more and be a servant in a certain capacity for a little while until God exalts them. And this is one of the things that is really, really destroying the ministry of God. But you know, God will always raise a remnant. And this is what we know, that God have His people all over. And the people don't understand. You say that God is omniscient and you say God is all this, but you don't realize that the same thing you're saying is what it is. God have His people everywhere. So you don't need to do nothing extra as a child of God. Once you have faith in God and you believe and you continue to lift His name up, He will make sure all the provisions you want is provided. And that is what He's trying to say. And this is where faith come in with dealing with and from the administrative level of the gospel and the scripture. All He asks you to do, lift my name. That's all you gotta do. Lift my name. Don't say nothing else. Just lift my name and I will draw all the people to sow into your ministries. I got my people out there. You know what I mean? So the people waiting to see you doing what God wants you to do, and they will come and bring the money for you. They want to see you doing it because they have the money, but you're not doing it, so they're not going to bother with you because they know you're on joke. When they see you, they know you're on joke. As you come, you're a bunch of joke. They know you're joking. People know you're joking. Listen, and one thing people forget, and I'll call and mention it earlier on. People in the world, you think they're stupid? You think people in the world who don't know and accepted Christ, you think they're stupid? You think you could fool them with nonsense? Let me tell you something. There are people who are not saved and they have more spiritual sense about the operation of the Holy Spirit more than you who claim to be saved. So don't feel you could fool them. No, you cannot fool people out there. That's why people out there are not studying certain people. They're not following you because they know you're not saying nothing. They know you're not in no light. You understand me? And so you cannot fool the people. You cannot fool them. That's why he said, just lift me up and I will draw men. Because if you draw men by invitation, oh, come to my church, well, they will come one day, but they ain't going to come back because you have nothing to keep them.
Exactly.
Hallelujah.
And if we just do what God tells us to do, like you said, my brother, as it is in the word, God is sovereign. He will take care
of course.
Everything. He's sovereign. We don't understand what sovereign means. Sovereign means that God is in total control.
Hallelujah.
There is no molecule. There is no little insignificant little things that we're thinking about that escape the control of God. Nothing whatsoever. He is sovereign.
Amen. You see, because the thing about it, a lot of us are not willing to suffer no way at all to come unto God. We are not willing. As much as we see all the sufferation that God, Jesus suffered on the earth, we don't feel that we need to go that route at all. Like I said, the average man would not be willing to go on the subway and give out tracts. The average pastor would not do it. I understand there are some pastors you have to put on gloves to give them something to drink. You understand me? The average man would not do it.
That's a joke, my brother.
Of course it's a joke. You know what I mean? But anyhow.
I know we could go on and on, my brother, but I know you got other stuff to do, man.
Glory to the name of Jesus.
It's a pleasure talking to you, man.
Amen.
We're going to continue that conversation. We're going to continue to lift up the name of Jesus.
We're going
to lift up the name of Jesus on the waters. Man, we just got to praise God.
Hallelujah, because he is the I am that I am.
Exactly,
glory.
My brother. One love.
Hey. My brother Michael Prince on the phone. 15 minutes before the hour of 1 o'clock. Let's take another caller. One more caller, I guess. Caller, good afternoon. Please turn off your radio.
Hello, Double.
Hey, good morning, sir.
Good morning. Now, you see where you went with that?
Went with what? Hold on. Went with what?
The thing I was saying to you, look, your friend come back and tell him the same thing.
Went with what? Caller, went with what? Tell me.
Double. Are you listening to what you're just saying, you're on the caller?
No, what we spoke on many things in many facets.
Okay,
we had a very long, prolonged conversation.
We have a long conversation.
Right.
I listened to your long conversation.
Right.
Okay? You went from where you was till you started talking about the pastors who don't give out tracts and the pastors who want big churches and all like that.
So are you against what I'm
you
saying?
Understand?
Are you against that?
I'm not against what you're saying, but some part of what you're saying, I didn't think you were supposed to get into that.
So let me ask you now, what is your mission right now in this country? What is your mission right now?
And then, my mission, you're saying something, I'm not calling to criticize you, because you always think when someone calls you, they're criticizing. You understand? I'm just saying to you that some of the things that you get into, okay, because I was telling you that before when you were telling me, no, I shouldn't say that. But you get right down into some deep in-depth things there with the churches, with how the administrative part and who they're choosing and because they have a nice car and all them kind of things. You get into some in-depth stuff. You understand what I'm saying? And these are some of the things that you were saying. I'm not saying what you're saying is not true. But the in-depth stuff that you get into, man, is like, when people hear that out there, they don't want to come. You understand what I'm saying? Hello?
I'm listening to you, sir. That's it? You finished? Hello? Hello, caller, you there? All right. Okay, that might be the last caller. Caller, good afternoon.
Bumbalo.
Hey, good afternoon.
Why that caller calling you with these kind of stuff? Like the word hit him.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
You know,
Jesus.
You don't listen to people. You know you're doing the right thing and you keep doing the good work. You're following Jesus. And you keep following Jesus.
Caller, I don't want to make it look like if I'm prejudiced based on you, because you're talking, saying what I am saying, or you're in alignment with what I'm saying. But based on the conversation, this last caller just say, do you see any reason for what he just called back and say? Really?
No, because, okay, the only way if it hit him, because it's like, okay, if you're doing the wrong thing, and you know that, okay, like you go before God, you never altar calling at the church, and they call, well, if your heart is not right, come up. And, you know, you remember that you're not doing the right thing. Sometimes you cry into the altar. You cry because you know that you was going wrong. You know? So there's like it. You know, it hit him. You know? So you keep, you're going to hit a lot of people. Let them call.
So in other words, it's a conviction.
Yeah. You know?
All right.
He's trying to change it up, you know. So you keep doing it. You keep doing it. You're going to bring them. You know, you keep doing the good work.
All right. Thank you, caller, for that information. All right. One more caller. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, 007.
Yes,
praise,
ma'am.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Thank you for
How
your call.
You?
I'm great in the name of Jesus.
Amen. Well, when I was listening and I heard, you know, you asking the question, you know, I mean, who are we following? The first scripture that came to my mind was the scripture of the young ruler. You know, when he came to Jesus and he asked Jesus, you know, what else should I do, good teacher? And he told him, you know, well, certain things. And he said, well, I've done all those things from my youth. And then he said, well, okay, well, sell everything that you have and follow me. And the rich ruler walked away sad. And it seems to me that, you know, that's the same thing that's going on in the church. Because, I mean, if you remember, there's the parable of the workers in the vineyard, when the Lord said, you know, at the ending of the day, at the ending of the, everyone, no matter if they came in early in the morning or they came in an hour before the ending of the day, they all going to get the same reward. And to me, it seems like, you know, that's what's happening with the churches, is that we tend to forget that, yes, it says, you know, that we're going to get the rewards in heaven, but at the ending of the day, we're all going to get the same reward. It doesn't matter what time they come in. And if you know you're not willing to follow Jesus, if you're not willing to follow the things that he's saying, then, you know, you're always going to find a problem, because people, when they were sitting listening to Jesus, some people did get up and walk away. Because, you know, the word of the Lord is always in like a parable, and the seed. And when it's thrown out, I mean, if you're not the soil for it to grow in, it's not going to grow. So you can't be upset with them, because, you know, that maybe that's not where, you know, they were supposed to be. So if they get up and walk away because the teaching is not, you know. But Jesus also said that you must be careful to do everything that, you know, when he was speaking about the Pharisees and the Sadducees, he said to follow what they say, but don't do what they do, because their deeds are not right. So,
amen.
Yes, you know, you listen to your leaders and you listen to the pastors, and they tell you which they are supposed to, because they have, as it said, you know, that they have taken to have to be seated in the chair of Moses. So they have taken to be, you know, in charge. And it is their responsibility to tell you to make straight the way of the Lord and to follow and to prepare, because the time is coming, the time is at hand, and that the king is coming, and that we have to read our Bible and we have to draw closer to him. And as we have to listen to that. And however it is they do, whatever they do, we are not to do that, because that's what Jesus said. He said it in the book of Matthew, and I believe also in the book of Mark, I'm not sure. And so he speak about that. So now this is what it is. These are the things that came to mind, that, you know, we have to understand that, as Jesus, like, he laid it out for us from the beginning. He told us that, you know, listen, you're going to have those that's going to come. They're going to be rich. They're going to be with a lot of things as a rich ruler. And they're going to be upset, because what it takes to follow Jesus is really and truly, you have to sacrifice yourself. You have to give up everything that you
have,
everything that you think that you knew in the past, every understanding. Because the book of Proverbs says, you know, the fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge. And therefore, you have to put that knowledge,
yes,
that you think you
indeed
had before tonight, and come and let him now water you, because he's the fountain of living waters. Let him, you know, nurture you and guide you. And he's the one who's going to be pruning you, because you are his special tree.
Amen.
You know, that he has planted. So this is why, you know, everybody's going to get offended. They're going to have this offense. They're going to have offense because they did it with Jesus. Because, you know, as I say, it's a parable. And not every, as you said, it's for some people to understand and for some people not to understand. So those who are sitting there in the church, they didn't get a message. The Lord didn't speak to them. The message wasn't for them. So they got up and went away. Maybe they went somewhere else until they got the message that was for them. And that's all they said. But to follow Jesus is to give up everything that you have, every understanding, everything that you thought that you knew before, and let Hallelujah. Him be the one that, you know, guide you and cleanse you.
Thank you for your contribution. That's what I had to say. All right, my sister, in Jesus' name. Thank you very much. Seven minutes before 1 o'clock, usually at 1 o'clock we open the phones and we say, which country bada? We're going to keep the phone line open a little bit longer, and then we're going to do the phone calls at 1:30. All right, so 1:30, I got a beautiful thing from Sister J. Let me tell you what the winner going to get today, if you tabulate correctly. I think that's one chocolate cake on top of this, and then she got like 16 cupcakes, big cupcakes, 16 cupcakes in one packet. Let's go to the phone again. Hey, caller, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Dabla. How you doing?
I'm doing great in the name of Jesus. How you doing,
sir? I just called to just take 1 minute of your time. This, the caller you got twice, and he called and didn't say anything.
Oh, the young man?
That's your test.
Oh, it's my test?
That's your test.
Well, let me tell you something, my brother. You know, the spirit of the living God is a spirit that never lies. And you know, I've invited that same young man to meet me one time that we can talk. And the Bible said, let your yea be your yea, and let your nay be your nay. Now, if you cannot do it, say, I'm not willing to meet up with you. You know, but so then the spirit of God is not a spirit that lies. People are known by what they do. That's more than what they say. And so he's one man that we have spoken about meeting up one time and having some discussion. I was spoken to another young man who didn't understand about the Sabbath implication on the spiritual level. And he said, well, let's discuss it. Let me hear what you got and let me tell you what I got. And let's sit down and have a reasoning together. And he himself never even called back. And many times people call the radio and say, look, my brother, take my number after and let's have a little talk and let's talk. So when we're going by the Bible, you know, the Bible is clear. And God is a fear God. Because God show you things in actuality as to what life entails. So many times it's not parable where we have to try to figure out if this is really true. Because God shows those things in reality, in real time. He show you the people that is out there. He show you what is in the vineyard. He show you. So that's why God is just such an awesome God, because God, he show you those things every day. But many of us is not willing to adhere to the things after we even see it. We still don't even believe what we see.
Some want God to be when they want him to be. And, you know, jump in line when they want him to jump in line.
Amen.
But, you know, when you stand for something, if you are a job and you are a boss or a supervisor and you stand for certain things, they're always going to be challenged. So there's no difference in the word of God. When you stand for the word of God and stand for him, there are going to be challenges.
Amen.
And if your challenges come right there where you're sitting right now, it's your challenge. I listened to a good portion of the program this morning. You know, I wouldn't call it a show. I call it a program.
Amen.
You know, because people need to understand program and show. Show is something you look pretty, you try to impress, and you keep getting up. But when you have a program, people say, did you hear, did you listen, did you see, did you know about, and how you feel about this program or that program. And people start to think about a program. But when you go to a show, you look forward to go back to a better show next year.
Hallelujah.
But Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever.
Amen.
He ain't no show. He is the real
thing. He is, indeed. And one thing what you're saying in terms of the same program that we have on today, it's a good light to show us who we are in Christ. Because yes, because the thing about it is, there are certain things that we as believers should not do or should do as believers, in terms of our speech, in terms of our patience, in terms of the way we exhibit what we exhibit. So all those things that in the same conversation we are able to prove or to see, different depiction of the Christian man in action, live before our ears, as to what it entails as a believer in Christ. You know what I mean?
That's right.
Amen.
That's right. You see, but you know, there's another twist to, you know, the human nature.
Hold on, caller.
You have believers and you have true believers. You have Christians and true Christians. So you're always going to have your tests going on day in, day out, because some are true, some are not true. They only follow the ritual and they just go for the formality.
They don't have the spirit.
Formality. Mm-hmm. Christian, formality in Christianity is a dangerous sin. Very dangerous. Because when you start to follow formality, what you say is what God, not what Christ say. What Christ say don't really matter. It's seasonal.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
And Christianity, you know, this Christian warfare is not seasonal. It's an ongoing thing. Every day you get up, as long as God gives you breath, you breathe the air.
We Hallelujah. Provide.
You understand?
Yes.
It's set there for us. So, you know, it's a continual thing. And once you don't have continuality in your Christian walk, in your faith, you're going to falter. You're going to find excuse. You know, sometimes I'm at the station and I listen. When I'm home or on the road, I listen to different programs. And the first thing comes up in my mind when I hear certain discussions is somebody's waiting to hear a mistake, to run with it, ridicule you and the person, and just bash them. And if you can forgive one another and see one another's fault and speak to your brother or your sister and say, look, I think so, let's look into this a little further, a little deeper, and see what we can get out of it. And if you can't come eye to eye with the truth in Christ, something is wrong.
Hallelujah. I got another caller on the line waiting for me, Pastor Green, sir. So thank you for the contribution.
Take your test, my brother.
And say hi to the family for me, in Jesus' name.
Yes, I will.
Okay, yes. Caller, thank you for waiting. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, my brother.
Yes,
you
my brother.
You don't want to talk to me or what?
I don't understand what you mean.
I said, you don't want to talk to me? All I'm saying to you is take my number and when you get off, we can talk. That's all I'm saying to you.
Oh, that's the 347, right? 706?
Yeah, 347. That's what I'm saying to you.
Oh, what's your name? What's your name?
My name is John.
John, it's a pleasure talking with you, my brother. And God is a miraculous God. And God,
yes, it's true.
God can fix and God can do all things. You know what I mean?
All things.
So I thank you for your contribution.
You.
I thank
but
you.
Call me at this number.
Yes.
When we get off, call me anytime, any hour.
No problem,
sir. All we can talk about is God.
Thank you very much, my brother.
Okay, we gotta lift up each other's hand. All
Amen.
We can talk about is God.
Amen, all my right? brother. In Jesus' name, thank
all
you.
Right. Okay. That's all we can talk about, God.
Okay, brother.
All right?
Jesus.
Okay. Hello.
Thank you.
All right.
Hey, caller, you're live. Good afternoon. Caller, good afternoon.
Hello?
Yes, hello, good afternoon. Good afternoon.
Hello?
Yes, good afternoon. Listen to your phone, not your radio.
Oh, good afternoon. I'm just calling to let you know that I do enjoy your program. It's very enlightening.
Amen.
So keep up the good work.
Any comment as to what is being said or anything that you want to add as based on what the context of the...
Okay, yeah, one of the comments, you were saying that like some pastors, they even like want to go give out tracts and things, and that's very true. You don't see any pastors or like high people in churches go out in the streets, like in the subways or, you know, just on the train or the buses and say, God loves you. Good morning. You know, just to tell people the love of God, show people the love of God. Everybody's like online today and everybody's like looking for a big church, a mega church. And it's very true. People like they lost that love.
Amen. But you see, the thing, as you call me, my sister, our duty is to, whenever we see something, the reason why we see it is because we have to say something about it or be a light. No, because the thing about it is, 10 people might be watching the exact same program, same picture, and everybody come out with something different, or 10 people watch the same thing, and one person can able to depict something very significant that the 9 other people did not see. That's what the Bible says, to whom much is given, much is required. So if you're in an organization and you see stuff going on, your duty is to say something and be a light, and that someone can able to come up to the standard or come to the level or wake up and come on, hey, do it right. So we all have a part to play, my sister, okay?
Yeah, thank you so much, my brother. Keep
thank
up the good work. God
in
bless
Jesus
you.
In Jesus' name, God bless you too. Thank you. Hey, caller, good afternoon.
Yes, good afternoon.
Afternoon, my sister.
I have a word of encouragement for you, specifically for you. If you let me read it.
Yes, ma'am.
From the word of God.
Hallelujah.
Let no man despise thy youth, but be thou an example of believers in word, in conversation, in charity, in spirit, in faith, in purity, till I come give attendance to reading, to exhortation, to doctrine. Neglect not the gift that is in thee, which was given to thee by prophecy, the laying on of hands, and of the presbytery. Meditate upon these things, give thyself fully to them, that thy prophecy may appear to all. Take heed unto thyself and unto the doctrine, continue in them, for it is in doing so, thou shalt both save thyself and them that hear thee. Paul was saying to Timothy here, briefly, that let no man despise thy youth. Timothy was a young man in the flesh. You are a young man in the spirit, a new believer then. So what I've been listening, and what I think is that something that because you just accepted the Lord, some might be saying, you know, you just come, leave that alone, don't trouble that yet, because you're not there yet. But Paul went on to say to Timothy, in 2 Timothy chapter 4, I charge you therefore before God and the Lord Jesus, who shall judge the quick and the dead at his appearing in his kingdom, preach the word, be instant in season and out of season, reprove, rebuke, exhort with all longsuffering and doctrine. For the time will come and they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lust shall they heap unto them their teachers and their engineers, and shall turn their ears away from the truth, their ears from the truth, and shall be turned unto fable. Watch thou in all things, in your affliction, do the work of an evangelist. Make full proof of your ministry. So I think that is part of the problem for some. You just got saved, and some think that don't touch that yet, because you just got saved. But preach the word. Preach the word. Let no man despise your spiritual youth.
Amen. Amen.
And one more thing. Jesus came preaching repentance, not doctrine.
Hallelujah.
What did Jesus say? Repent.
And
for
be
the
baptized.
Kingdom of heaven
is at hand. Hallelujah.
He did not preach any doctrine.
Hallelujah.
He said, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. And that is the what the church should be doing today, preaching the gospel of repentance. That's
Hallelujah.
What it's all about.
Amen.
Repent,
amen.
For the kingdom of heaven is at hand.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank
you,
my sister, in Jesus' name. Thank you for that, indeed. That was 1 Timothy 4:12. Yeah, definitely, indeed, man. And you know, the word of God is so clear. And I met a young man in a parking lot, and I was just talking to him about Jesus, and he just said to me immediately, "Oh, I'm a Catholic." So I asked him, "What's a Catholic?" And the guy was stunned. Stunned, the white guy, he was stunned and shocked that somebody actually asked him, "What is a Catholic?" Hallelujah, Jesus. I tell you, Jesus just give you the words, man. I asked him, "What is a Catholic?" And he couldn't go no further. No further. Glory to the name of Jesus. It's not about religion or nothing like that. It's about having a relationship with Jesus Christ. That's what he's calling for. That is what he's yearning for. You know what I mean? And I mentioned to the guy, we were talking about praying to the Holy Mary. And immediately the Spirit just tackled me one time in my head. I said, there are many great basketball players on the court. When you see their parents, their mother, do you go and tell them, "Oh, you did a great job"? No, they're just their mothers. Sometimes their mothers don't even like the sport that they play. Glory to the name of Jesus. So that's the same example. And the Holy Spirit lead you into all truth and all wisdom. I'm telling you, man, you'll be amazed at what the Spirit leads you to, just like that. Don't care who you are. If you submit yourself to the Spirit of the Holy Ghost, you will be amazed at what you can achieve, what you can say, what you can perceive, what you can know about things in the Spirit without people telling you. That is the way God works his spirit. You know what I mean? To the people who are willing to submit and listen to the Holy Spirit. Because I said to the guy, I said, look, he said that they pray to, yeah, they pray to Mary and this and this. I said, well, you know, Mary is the mother of Jesus. Yeah, we understand that. But I'm saying to you, with all the basketball players or great football players or great athletes who, you know, they raised a child and the child came out to be good or powerful in whatever. When you see the mother, can the mother do the same thing? Does the mother have the same power? You see what I'm saying? And that's the way the Holy Spirit leads you into how to get to his people, to let them understand some basic fundamental truths. You know, realistical, just spiritual truth that is so, you know, realistic. And the thing about it is, what God is hoping is that mankind will not listen to people, but listen to his reasoning through his word, because everybody who read the Bible can clearly see the Bible said have no other gods but me. No, how much clearer does that have to go? Can any man therefore tell you to do something beyond the word of God and you're going to do it to pray to somebody else? Come on, I mean, that's really the basic thing about it. You know, God wants you to be strong in yourself. And in the same reading that the lady just called and read, the First Timothy reading, don't let no man look down on you. The preacher could be who the preacher is. He could have all what he have, and that had nothing to do with nothing. If you're not showing me, thus said the Lord in the scripture, I'm not going to be willing to follow what you're saying. And that's what the word of God is trying to tell us. Don't care what they're telling you. If it does not line up with the Bible, it's not in there. There is no example of it in the Bible. Why do you follow it? Why do you do it? You must let them tell you where it is in the Bible, and then don't feel that you don't have what it takes. Question these people, because Pastor Ferdinand always said, you know, you end up in hell, you're going to ask him what you did here, what are you doing here. But the point is, it's going to be too late for you. It's going to be too late to say, well, somebody told you the wrong thing. No, you have enough time to find out what is right from wrong. And that is how God works. And that's why I love Jesus, because he is a fair God. He gives you enough time. There are people who say they could have been dead already. Why are you not dead yet? Because God is giving you enough time to make sure you get it right. And you do it right, because his wish is that none should perish. What a God we serve. Eh? Give him some praise. Eh? Hallelujah to the name of Jesus. What a Jesus. Hallelujah. What a God we serve. All the chances he's given us to make sure that none of us perish. Not even one. You think when you listen to the program and you hear certain things, you think it's by chance? No. He's talking to you through the words. Are you willing to humble yourself and get rid of your opinions and your religious beliefs and background? Strip yourself naked and hearken unto the word of the Lord. That's what he's asking. Hallelujah. So we're getting ready. We're going to go into the which country battle at 1:30. That's what we're going to do it at 1:30. So I'm going to just keep the phone open still for anybody out there. If you still want to call and it's a very important conversation, as we look at the mirror, at all of us. We look at ourselves in the mirror and really find out, who are we really following? Are we following Jesus? I was explaining to a young man a few days ago, we were talking, and man, this guy was equipped. He is like an open a can of worms. A young man down by Carroll Street and Utica Avenue was just, you know, he had all kinds of books, including his Bible, in his car. And he keep going across the street, say, wait, right there. He get me another book. Come back with another scripture. Come back with another thing. And he keep going back and forth. And we was just going on with the Bible and stuff like that. And I'm telling you, he definitely knows a lot of stuff. He knows a lot of stuff, but he's not willing to admit or to believe that God has chosen pastors, apostles, and preachers, and bishops in different areas. He said he don't want to listen to no man at all. No man. He's not going to listen to no man. No, I'm not telling him to listen to man, but you got to give them credit in their respective places, because we all are important in the body of Christ. So as much as you're not going to follow them, you have to also understand that God has chosen many people just like you. The same way you have the Spirit, God has chosen many people. So you got to give them credit where credit is due. You know what I'm saying? So that's one thing he wasn't willing to get in at all. He said he's not listening to no, you know, he's not listening to no pastor, nothing like that. He's just listening to God, and nothing wrong with that. Of course, you got to listen to God. But everybody here, we are part of the body of Christ, and every part of the body of Christ is important. Everybody have a job to do. Every part of the body is essential for the workings of the body. You know what I mean? So we need to lean onto our own understanding, but do the best we can in the Spirit of God, and the Spirit lead you to all truth. You know what I mean? Hallelujah, Jesus. So I'm gonna shut down the phone at 1:15, but at 1:30 we're gonna do the phone in. Which country, Bada? That's when you call to represent your country where you're from. That's at 1:30, all right? So those who look forward to that exercise, at 1:30 we're gonna do that. In 2 more minutes, I'm gonna close the phone line. If you're out there, you want to make a contribution in love. And like I said before to the previous callers, you know, our intention is not to create a confusion. Like, you know, just a bunch of conversation that nobody could learn nothing from. That's not our intention at all. It's for us to conversate in the Spirit of God, in the Spirit of love, that we can all elevate and emulate the Word of God in truth and in the good Spirit of God, the Spirit of love, that we all can improve. And I always say, you know, if I come on the radio and I might pose a question and it's not properly stated, I could pose it a better way that we can maximize the potential of the question. I encourage you, call me up and say, man, you know, I think if you say it like that, it will have a better application or better implications in terms of the listeners. I'm open to that. You know, I continue to try to grow in terms of my patience in dealing with the callers. And this is, as a child of God, that's what we all have to do. Try to leave room for improvement in our performance as believers in Christ. And this is some of the basic fundamental things that we have made up in our mind that we don't want to do. Because I was saying to the same guy I was talking about before, I would say a lot of us are willing to do a lot of things that the Bible recommend for us to do as believers. But there comes a time when there are certain things that we make up our mind that we're not going to do it. And I was talking about, like, back in the Caribbean, you know, well, even in America too, but back in the Caribbean, we know that you have men that have a lot of kids all over the place with all different women everywhere. It's something that's been in the culture from back in the island. We can relate to that. And then one of the child might not get the proper treatment from that father. You know, and the father really and truly, you know, he's innocent. You know, he wasn't raised with a proper father. He wasn't raised in the proper household. He was not taught these things. He never had it in him. You know, your mother probably liked him and they had a child and whatever it is. Now you're growing up in American society, in American situation, understanding the importance or seeing the relevance of the father relating to the mother and the child and all that. Now you make up in your mind that because your father didn't raise you or he didn't treat you right, you will never forgive him. This man, he never raised me. He never did this, he never did. But guess what? To whom much is given, much is required. A person cannot give you what they don't have. You know what I mean? He couldn't give you more. He, you know, even back in the islands with parents, you know, you might tell your mother, oh, mommy, I love you, or your grandmother, I love you. Why go wash the dishes? But you love me. What do you love me? What love? Go. They don't mean anything, but that's the way they were raised. They cannot give you more. So when it comes to the forgiveness part, we have to make up our mind that we are willing to forgive every single person. It doesn't make a difference. What was the transgression? Because many people cannot give, not many people, but people cannot give you what they don't have. If I was not raised in a certain way, how can I do this for you? How can I tell you this? I was never raised like that. You know what I'm saying? So as believers in Christ, there is no limitation to, because when God says, how many times should I forgive? And he says 70 times 7, it's just a figure of speech, that there is no limitation to forgiveness. And forgiveness is one of the biggest thing and hindrance in the kingdom of God for believers. In terms of seeing the manifestation of God in your life, forgiveness is one of the strongest and most potent. You know, is one of the thing that God just really and truly look forward to. is forgiving others. It's something that he really and truly looked forward to. So I'm saying this just to just refine and you know, just, you know, revitalize our belief system in terms of forgiveness as a child of God. There are many people that we are not willing to forgive them because of their transgression against us. But many of them were in a position where they couldn't do better. They didn't know better. They really have no choice in the matter. They could not do better. They could not do better. You know what I mean? Many times you might, you know, your father might, you talk to your father and you might be educated and he don't even know how to talk to you. And he might be just saying, so how you doing? Are you okay? Are you all right? Yes. And you're trying to ask him certain thing and he just say, so you okay? So you good? Oh, well, you're looking beautiful. Oh, yeah. He don't have no education. He don't have the information to relate to the way that the world nowadays tell you that he should be relating to you. So you have to use wisdom and understand that, well, he's just being him. Or she's just being her. You know what I mean? You might blame your mother and say your mother gave you up for adoption when you were young. I mean, sometimes in the best interest of your survival and being something in society, she did the best at the time with the information that she had, the limited information that she had, or based on what it is. So she made a move. You might think it to be bad, but probably where she was in her life, she felt it was the best thing to do for your survival. And you have survived. Now you find it hard to forgive her because she, you know what I mean? So all these little things that we have to look at as believers and make sure that we dot in every I and we cross in every T that we can get it right with our Father. Because a lot of us, we're praying for things and they're not coming through in our timing. But then sometimes God is waiting for us. Like many of us pray this prayer, forgive me as I forgive those. God is waiting for you to forgive so that he can do his part. So many times that is what the hindrance is. You ask God to forgive me as I forgive those who trespass against me. So unless you don't forgive those who trespass against you, God is waiting for you to do your part. You know what I mean? 20 minutes past the hour, so we're going to definitely, the phone is shut down. And thank everyone for listening today. And, you know, thank you for sharing, all those who were brave enough to call and had something to share. We thank you for sharing. And it's definitely Choice Radio, your life, your salvation, your choice. And we came from out in the world, so we really and truly have no time to play with the word of God. We're not in this for no game. We're not in this for no reputation. We don't want to be known by man. So we are very serious about the work of God and the word of God. And so sometimes we might sound a little different from the average Christian station because we are passionate about where we came from. What has been done in our lives. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Accept Jesus today and change your life. Change your destiny with Choice Radio. Life has always been about choices. Make the right choice today and choose Jesus. Choice Radio, your life, your salvation, your choice. Log on to www.westindianpeople.com to view us live. Also, listen on your cell phones by dialing 213-493-0146. Life begins with Jesus. Choice Radio. Stay tuned. Stay inspired. Stay in Jesus.
All right, so guys, don't forget at 1:30 we'll be doing Which Country Bada. If you're a first time listener, what we do, we open the phone lines and you call as much as you can get through. And wherever you're from, you just shout your country loud and proud. And make sure no slogans. Don't say Trini, say Trinidad. Don't say Greens, say Grenada. Don't say Vincey, say St. Vincent, all right? So that's going to be the criteria of it. And call as much as you can to get your country to win, all right? And make sure you do the tabulation today because we have a beautiful prize. Let me make sure this is a whole chocolate cake. Let me see if it's a whole chocolate cake. I think it's a whole chocolate cake with a white cream topping on top of it. And then we have 16. We have 16 cupcakes. In big cupcakes in another package. I mean, it's really looking good, and you know, so that's the winner gonna receive that today. So if you tabulate correctly as to all the calls received from the various islands, all right, so get your crew together from your country to make sure your country win today, and then also tabulate to have the right numbers, all right? Indeed. So we're gonna take a break and be right back in Jesus' name.
Day, get ready to cruise on the high waters. It's time again to lift up the name of Jesus in praise underwater. The second edition of Praise Underwater, Labor Day. The name that is above every name will be lifted on high aboard the Golden Sunshine. Pier 2, Emmons Avenue, Shipshed Bay. Leave in the dock at 9 a.m. sharp, so boarding time must be 8 a.m. Labor Day Monday, get ready for the biggest cruise underwater. Bringing on the praise, more than a conqueror, Janice Charles.
That's who I am in
it
you.
Will be praise of fire. Praise of fire.
Fire, everybody, man, your post. Fire. Get filled with the Holy Ghost.
Also appearing live is the anointed one from St. Lucia, Burda Emerald.
If you have a talent, you
praise on the water. Looks like a sea song. Making a special guest appearance is Michael Prince, and a surprise performer will perform. Brace yourself, saints of God. You would never leave the same way you came. It's gonna be Praise Underwater. Get your tickets now. Children under 13, you pay $25. Adults, you pay $45. Tickets available at Tasty Parties, 3122 Church Avenue, between East 31st and East 32nd Street. Bruce's Parties, 9509 Church Avenue, between East 95th and 96th Street. Or buy your tickets online from www.choicegospelnetwork.com or call 646-436-5555. 347-663-8638 or 347-443-5473. We're serving your free food with the best DJs. Brother Edwin, Bishop Anderson, 007, Pastor Green, Minister Glenn, and more. This Labor Day Monday morning, we are sailing for Jesus on the Golden Sunshine. Pier 2, Emmons Avenue, Shipshed Bay, 9 a.m. sharp. Jesus, He's Lord. He's Lord.
Troubles and trials will come your way.
And this will be a spirit-filled boat ride. It won't be this kind of worldly. You're gonna be make sure you come prepared to pray and lift the praise to the Almighty God. We also got tickets over there at Labby Market, Nostrand Avenue and Fenimore. Midwood thing is Midwood, yeah. Midwood and yeah, all right. Labby Market also have tickets for this event indeed.
Hold your sense here. Come on, blow for 10. Are you ready tonight? Can I hear you scream? Joyous celebration!
Joyous celebration!
Joyous celebration!
Joyous,
hey! Put us hands together! We hear your praise! Are you ready tonight? Look for 10! I saw the very big God.
Oh, hallelujah.
So get ready for that was 1 o'clock, right? Get ready for 1:30. Which country bada? Take out your phone. Can it be Panama today? Miss Panama, good evening to you.
My God, you fine.
Can it be Antigua? Barbuda, Belize.
My God.
Grenada again. Can it be Jamaica?
My God, you
can it be St. Vincent, St. Lucia, Barbados, Guyana? Can it be Trinidad? Can it be Haiti? The last time we did it, Jamaica, with a big showing of
when I look to my right,
39 points,
I look to my right,
followed by Grenada with 23. Well, we gotta say Trinidad first,
to my back,
followed by Trinidad with 24 points. Beat Grenada by 1 point, 23. St. Vincent with 17 points. A tie between Guyana and Haiti with 9 points. A tie between Panama and Belize with 4 points. Yeah. It's dynamic every time the numbers change.
Oh, hallelujah. I serve a very big God.
Hey, Sister Maggie.
Hallelujah.
Oh,
I know you like your African.
Oh, hallelujah, I serve a very big God. Oh, hey!
Jump around for Jesus, man. I'm gonna tell you one secret, believers, right? I'm gonna tell you one secret, right? You see, God wants to know that you really believe what you believe. He wants to know that you are sold out for Him. There are times the enemy gonna try to transgress and make you feel down in spirit, down in everything. You know what? When you show Jesus that I'm still reveling in your name, I'm still praising you, I'm still worshiping you, guess what? He love it. And Holy Spirit will just overtake you and give you victory. Glory. Hey Malik,
I see you check your body right now.
Hey Justin, good afternoon, man.
Check your body, check your body, check. Praise the Lord with your dance. Check your body, check your body, check your body, check your body. Are you ready to celebrate Bloemfontein? Come on, let's go. Celebrate, 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 celebrate. Let me hear you scream. Hey, my God is good, oh.
Which country, but at 1 o'clock?
Hey.
Oh, God, sorry. 1:30. 1:30, get your phones ready. Call as much as you can.
Everything a double, double, no. Everything a double, double, no. Promotion double, double, no. Your money double, double, no. Your house a double, double, no. Your cars a double, double, no. Hallelujah! In the morning when I wake up, I will sing my praise unto you, my Lord. I will shout, I will dance to you. You have been my help forever, ever.
Are you ready?
God is good.
1:30.
Somebody scream!
Call as much as you can. The number is 347-663-8638. Whatever country you're from, just shout your country loud and proud when you get on the phone lines. Tell me, Kola, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from, Kola?
Diana.
347-663-8638. Tell me, Kola, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Trinidad.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Ooh, 347-663-8368. Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Diana.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Ooh, tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Haiti.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Yeah,
tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Oh, yeah. 347-663-8638. Let your finger do the work, kid. Which country, Badara? Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Guyana.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
My goodness. 347-663-8. Hey, tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from?
Guyana.
Oh, yeah. Which country, brother? Who can get the most phone calls inside? Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Hey, tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Guyana.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Trinidad.
My goodness. 347-663-8638. The most calls win. Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Trinidad.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
St. Lucia.
Ooh. 347-663-8638. Which country, brother? Let your finger do the walking. Patience is a virtue. That's when we test your patience and your patriotism. Yes. Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Trinidad and Tobago.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Trinidad.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Guyana.
347-638-638. Which country, brother? 133. Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Haiti.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from, Connor? Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Trinidad.
My goodness, I tell you, this race is serious. Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Guyana.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
My goodness, my brother, good evening to you. Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Trinidad and Tobago.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada, Caracuan, PD, Miami.
All right. Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from, Connor?
Jamaica.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from,
Connor?
Can Jamaica do it today? Can Trinidad do it? Can Grenada do it? Can Guyana do it? Is it possible? 347-638-638. Can Guyana? Can Haiti do it? Who can do it? Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Haiti.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from, Connor?
Jamaica.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from, Connor?
Trinidad.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Guyana.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada, Caracuan, PD, Miami.
What a girl, bright girl. 347-638-638. Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Say it again.
Grenada.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from, Connor? Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Trinidad.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Trinidad.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Haiti.
Ooh, anybody could win this one. Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Ten more minutes. Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Guyana.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Ooh, anybody could win this one. I tell you, it's looking good for all the countries so far. Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
347-638-638. Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from, Connor?
Jamaica.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? 9 more minutes. Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Guyana.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Trinidad.
My goodness. Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Trinidad and Tobago.
Well, don't give up at all. Don't give up at all. Don't ever stop calling. Don't stop. 347-663-8638. Make your country loud and proud. Yes. Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from, Connor?
Jamaica.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Haiti.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Ooh, will you be proud of your country? 347-663-8638. 9 more minutes to go. Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Guyana.
My goodness. 347-66. Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Trinidad and Tobago.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from, Connor? Connor, where you from? I still with you. Where you Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Guyana.
My God. Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica. Jamaica.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Trinidad.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Tell me, Connor, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Trinidad.
347-663-8638. 7 more minutes to go. Tell me, color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Tell me, color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Tell me, color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Trinidad.
Tell me, color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Tell me, color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
My goodness, Jamaica on fire. 347-663-8638. 8 more minutes. Tell me, color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Diana.
My goodness. Tell me, color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Trinidad.
7 more minutes. Tell me, color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Triple 7-6-6-3-8-6-3-8. Tell me, color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Tomato.
Tell me, color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from, color? Color, you there? I gone. Tell me, color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Tell me, color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Tell me, color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from, color?
Grenada.
Tell me, color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Tell me, color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
St. Lucia.
Tell me, color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Trinidad and Tobago.
Tell me, color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from, color?
Grenada.
Tell me, color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
My God. Tell me, color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Guyana.
Tell me, color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Oh, your voice loud. 347-663-8638. Which country, Badara? Tell me, color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Tell me, color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Tell me, color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Guyana.
Tell me, color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Oh, my Jamaican partner, how you doing, man? 347-663-8638. 5 more minutes. Tell me, color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from, color?
Jamaica.
Tell me, color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Guyana.
Tell me, color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Tell me, color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Haiti.
Tell me, color, where you from? Where you from?
Guyana.
Yes. Tell me, color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Tell me, color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Haiti.
Tell me, color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from, Kola? Where you from? Kola, where you from? Alright, you gone. Tell me, Kola, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Tell me, Kola, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Trinidad.
4 more minutes to go indeed. 347-63863. Tell me, Kola, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Tell me, Kola, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Tell me, Kola, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Tell me, Kola, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from, Kola? Kola, where you from? I'm
Jamaica.
Moving. All right. Tell me, Kola, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? All right, you gone. 347-63-8638. Tell me, Kola, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Tell me, Kola, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Guyana.
4 more minutes to go, indeed. 347-663-8638. Who get the most phone calls on the inside? Tell me, Kola, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Tell me, color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Whoop. Tell me, color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Trinidad and Tobago.
My God. Tell me, color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
My goodness, I tell you what, a fire. 347-663-8638. 3 more minutes to go. Which country, Bada? Who Bada? Who Badara? Yes. Tell me, color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from, Kola?
Jamaica.
Tell me, Kola, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Diana.
Tell me, Kola, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from, Kola?
Guyana.
Oh, Guyana making a big move today. 347-663-8638 indeed. 2 more minutes to go. Tell me, Kola, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Trinidad.
Tell me, Kola, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada, Grenada.
Hey. Tell me, color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Oh, yeah. Tell me, color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
What you mean, man? Tell me, color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Guyana.
What you mean? What you mean? What you mean? One more minute to go. 347-6638-638. Which country, Badara? Tell me, Kola, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Tell me, Kola, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Guyana.
Tell me, Kola, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Trinidad.
Tell me, Kola, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Where you? Tell me, Kola, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Trinidad and Tobago.
Oh yeah. Tell me, Kola, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Haiti.
Yeah. Tell me, Kola, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Tell me, Kola, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? My goodness. Tell me, Kola, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from, Kola? Where you from?
Sound the horn.
Where you from, Kola? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
My goodness.
For the outpouring of the Holy Ghost.
In the upper room.
In the upper room, we watch.
Hey, Kola, where you from and what's nice about your Guyana country this evening? What's nice about Guyana, Kola? What's nice about Guyana? Tell us.
Yes.
What is nice?
Love gold. Love gold. Nice loving people.
My goodness. So the gold on the, around the street or what? Where you find the gold?
Yeah. You find the gold in the street.
All in your backyard. I hear that person. All in your backyard, right?
Yeah.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Kola. Indeed.
That's why
you find gold under the street in Guyana, boy. 44 minutes past the one, it's Choice Radio. Your life, your salvation, your choice. Jesus is the choice.
Yeah.
Hey, caller, good afternoon. Where you from and what's nice about your country this evening?
I'm from Guyana.
And what's nice about Guyana, the previous caller didn't mention. What's nice?
They're so respectable and they're so outgoing.
They're outgoing?
Yes.
So what that mean though? What does that mean?
It means that we do everything with respect.
All right, young man, thank you. All right. Hey, caller, good afternoon. What's nice about your country and where you're from? All right, that person, the one, that kind of thing. Caller, good afternoon. What's nice about your country and where you're from?
I'm from Guyana.
You're from Guyana.
Well, the land of Guyana.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
What? Have many waters.
Mm-hmm.
They have tourist areas. We're very respectful. We deal with, you know, everything good. And most of it, I would like to know that, you know, the people be safe.
Amen. So let me ask you something. So overall, you're a proud representation of Guyana. You're proud of where you're from.
Yes, I am.
And you wouldn't change anything.
100%. Yes.
If you have to be born in Guyana, you do it all over again, right?
If I have to do.
If you'll have to do it all over again, you'll be born the same way, same thing, no change, right?
No change.
Amen. Glory to God.
100% to the bone.
Amen, my sister. Thank you indeed. Hey, caller, good afternoon. Where you from and what's nice about your country this evening?
Hello?
Hey, good afternoon. Where you from and what's nice about your country? What's nice?
I'm from Guyana, and Guyana is a beautiful country.
Mm-hmm.
And one thing I want to say to this week, I like how Guyanese come out and support.
Wow, Guyana on fire today. Yes, indeed.
You know, I said, I give Guyanese a big shout out. Come out, tell a brother, tell a friend.
Indeed.
We gotta make it.
Indeed, in Jesus'
you
name.
You know, we live with love and unity.
Amen.
Remember Eddie Neb, let's sing love and unity, peace and harmony. So we have to support that.
Amen. In Jesus' name. Thank you, my sister. All right.
Yay.
146. It is Choice Radio. Your life, your salvation, your choice indeed. Yay. We just lifting up the name of Jesus, man. And I'm proud to be saved. I'm proud to be born again. I'm proud to be a child of God, you know what I mean? And I'm not ashamed to tell nobody that.
The outpouring of the Holy.
Indeed. We're just proud to be born again, proud to be new in spirit, new in mind.
In prayer,
as we continue to work in on the new, complete renewal of our mind.
God,
that we can relate to God.
We will
and relate to Jesus Christ in our life, you know what I mean?
Voice.
So I'm encouraging you, if you're out there in Radio Land,
one
be proud that you're born again.
The hearts with fire.
Hallelujah.
Everybody, man, your post.
So what we're going to do, the prize that we're going to give out for the person who get the right numbers correct, the country who wins today, from that country, we're going to try to find somebody from that country that wins today to get the other 16 cupcakes, all right? There's another 16 cupcakes in one package by itself. The winner, official winner, gonna get 16 cupcakes in a package with another chocolate cake with a cream topping on top of it. It's looking beautiful, it's well packaged, it's looking nice. Those who online could see it over there on the side. To my right, you can see those online, choicegospelnetwork.com. And we encourage you to tell a friend about Choice Radio, tell a friend about Choice Gospel Network, because all we want to do is lift up the name of Jesus. That's all we want to do, is lift up the name of Jesus. And we just thank God for the privilege. We thank God for all the blessings on Choice Radio, that we are able to dispense the gospel. We are able to bring some clarity and good quality program that can enlighten and enhance our community, our people, and in our walk with God. We thank God for all his favors. We thank God for all those who is praying diligently for Choice Radio, that we will continue to lift up the name of Jesus, that men and women will be proud to hear their God be lifted up in that kind of manner. And we pray for everybody who come on Choice Radio to come with the same intention, to lift up the name of Jesus. Yes, that he will draw men unto him indeed. Oh Lord. Oh Lord. So we're going to come back and tabulate. In the meantime, do your tabulations.
Amen.
You can open the phone lines just now for your tabulation. If you tabulated, the person with the correct tabulation will receive a beautiful, beautiful, a double cake package. One is a chocolate cake with a cream on topping on top. And the next is 16 cupcakes. Well packaged, well looking nice. So we'll be right back after this right here. Keep it locked, Choice Radio.
Dice Lebanon, get ready to cruise on the high waters. It's time again to lift up the name of Jesus in praise underwater. The second edition of Praise Underwater, Labor Day. The name that is above every name will be lifted on high aboard the Golden Sunshine. Pier 2, Emmons Avenue, Shipshed Bay. Leave in the dock at 9 a.m. sharp, so boarding time must be 8 a.m. Labor Day Monday, get ready for the biggest cruise underwater. Bringing on the praise, more than a conqueror, Janice Charles.
Janice Charles. That's who I am in.
It will be praise of fire. Praise of fire.
Fire, everybody, man, your post. Fire. Get filled with the Holy Ghost.
Also appearing live is the anointed one from St. Lucia, Brother Emerald.
If you have a talent, you
praise on the water. Superstar. Making a special guest appearance is Michael Prince, and a surprise performer will perform. Brace yourself, saints of God. You would never leave the same way you came. It's gonna be Praise Underwater. Get your tickets now. Children under 13, you pay $25. Adults, you pay $45. Tickets available at Tasty Parties, 3122 Church Avenue, between East 31st and East 32nd Street. Bruce's Party is 9509 Church Avenue, between East 95th and 96th Street. Or buy your tickets online from www.choicegospelnetwork.com or call 646-436-5599. 347-663-8638 or 347-443-5473. We're serving you free food with the best DJs. Brother Edwin, Bishop Anderson, 007, Pastor Green, Minister Glenn, and more. This Labor Day Monday morning, we are sailing for Jesus on the Golden Sunshine. Here to Emmons Avenue, Sheepshed Bay, 9 a.m. sharp. Jesus, he's Lord. He's Lord.
Troubles and trials will come your way.
Round two of the playoffs in New York's most exciting soccer tournament, the Caribbean Cup, kicks off this Sunday, August 18th, with two monster games at the Sports Complex, Flatlands and Shepherd in Brooklyn. 3:15, Haiti take on St. Kitts Nevis, while at 5:30, many times champions Jamaica go head on with upset-minded Panama. New York, New Jersey, Connecticut. Lend me your ear. It's Caribbean Cup Championship Soccer Playoffs this Sunday, August 18th at the Spacious Thomas Jefferson High School Sports Complex, Flatlands and Shepherd in Brooklyn. 3:15, Haiti take on St. Kitts Nevis, while at 5:30, many times champions Jamaica go head on with upset-minded Panama. So come one, come all, and enjoy Sunday in the Park with Caribbean Cup Championship Soccer Playoffs for only $10 at the gate. Again this Sunday, Haiti St. Kitts Nevis at 3:15, Jamaica Panama at 5:30. Caribbean Cup Championship Soccer Playoffs is like dubbing. It's a must.
Caribbean Cup.
All right, so if you tabulated in the previous competition with the phone callers and you think you have the right numbers from the various islands, it's your time to call and let us hear what you've tabulated, what you heard. Indeed, the winner gets a beautiful, beautiful package here. I mean, just a beautiful package. It's a beautiful package indeed. Beautiful package. And the winner overwhelmingly is Jamaica. So a Jamaican will get the second package, 16 cupcakes. Yes. We're gonna figure out a way to give that to the winning country today. So the number here is 347-663-8638. If you tabulated, that's your time to call me and let me hear what you got for Grenada, what you got for Jamaica, how many for Trinidad, how many for St. Lucia, how many for Guyana, how many for Haiti, how many for Belize. Yes. 347-663-8638. Hope you're in a good mood today. You have to always strive to be in a good mood. You know that, right? Yes. You have to always strive to do that. You have to strive. The Bible says in 1 Thessalonians 5 and 18, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. Hey, caller, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Double O.
Yes, sir, how you doing, man? What you got?
Good afternoon, hi. Listen, amen. I hate to be a party pooper, you know.
Well, now, hold on. Party, you know, once you hate to be a party pooper, don't do it, at least. You're hating don't it already. It? Before you do it, don't do it. Because don't...
All right, then, I will call back then.
All right.
Because I don't want to be the first caller and to take away the cake.
Yeah, you're saying you have the numbers?
How you mean?
Man, if you know you have the numbers, give us the numbers in Jesus.